October 13th, 2013. You're listening to the Red Light District Show. How? Woo! It's Friday, it's payday, and there's no other place you'd rather be. This week on the Red Light District Show, we have the Jelly! And we will also feature Little Shop of Horrors. Roger, my buddy sent me a text message right now. Wanted me to make sure I got something right. The cast from left to right. Dirty Phil Amoroso. First time on the Real cast. Call her Missy. Fuse. Chris Brain. Chris Austin. Dennis Coley Jr. Adrian, we called her Bro. We'll continue the tradition. Bro. And Ansel Bartley.
Happy 2013 there, Tim.
And I am your host, Tim Amoroso, and you are listening to Ventura County's number one radio station. 2 years running.
That means it's true. Anything you say on radio.
Is this thing on?
Yeah.
All right, sorry.
We also have a no-cover writer. We have two no-cover writers in the house. Silvie, I'm not even going to try to butcher the last name at all. And Madeline McPhee. Big shouts out. I fucked up big time with you guys, huh? You're listening to Red Light Your Show only at Spreaker.com, Radio Breaker, you're listening to Radio.com, the Red Light to Show.com, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram. Every week I say I gotta get with Weston about these other websites. But guess what? We're a lot of places. Welcome to the show. Hey guy. Alright, let me see. Before I forget, tonight, King's Revenge. They'll be at Sans Souci. 9 to close. Always a good time when they're hitting the stage. One of my favorite bands of Ventura County. Go to our YouTube page. Within 2 weeks, we are going to I'm going to have Kitty in here, and I am going to get whooped by her. What does she do?
Flogging.
I'm gonna get flogged.
I thought you already did that.
No,
I didn't miss it.
The goal was to get to 250, and we are right now at 587. So
whoa. So you need to get double flogged.
No, it's this.
So that fast tracks right into my flogging.
We have to hold hands flogging.
This is news to me.
What? No, wait a minute.
It was all right. So it's 200, and then if we got to 250, it would be me. And if we got to 300,
and then
it
I got
be him.
I got whipped and I liked it, so then I started to do the challenge.
And then
it's basically how it happened.
If we got to 350, we hold hands and get whipped.
So now you guys got to hold hands? I think you should hold something else while you're getting whipped.
Okay. You like dick. That's fine.
I never said that. Why are you talking like that? That's ridiculous.
You're gross. You're embarrassing me. You're my dad.
Phil, what are your top 25 dicks?
Russell Crowe?
That you love.
Which member of Led Zeppelin do you think has the biggest dong?
You guys don't know about Phil Amoroso and Russell Crowe, right?
do.
Now you're making up the story again.
Who knows? Who's
that? I do.
Oh, yeah.
I do, yeah.
All right. So what it is with...
Don't make up stories. No.
Dad. All right. So me and my brother and my uncle and my dad were sitting in the backyard.
Your uncle? Who?
Jeff.
He's not your uncle.
At the time, he was my fucking uncle, dude.
Was he?
Yeah. He was married to Silvia. He was at your house. That's what... You marry into the family, your uncle, right?
Yeah, whatever.
Okay. So in Jeff, he was like, all right, so if you got to, like, be with one man, who would you want to be? And he was like, he went first.
Wait a minute, was you three guys? This was your conversation?
It was four.
Four dudes?
My brother.
No girls?
No chicks.
All right.
Just talking.
You know, I'm just saying because the guys in my family don't ask questions like that.
Yeah, I know.
Anyway,
yeah, but Tim does, so now you know how
it is. Not there's anything wrong with that.
No, nothing wrong with that at all, Dad. You didn't hear him? So there's nothing wrong with it.
No, that's his opinion. And if that's
okay,
how he wants to
so
be. Yeah.
My Uncle Jeff was like, well, I like Brad Pitt. I like to hold Brad Pitt. And then my dad was like, you know who's pretty badass to hold? It's Russell Crowe.
I never said that.
Badass?
He even, if you don't believe me, he has the fucking Russell Crowe tattoo on his arm.
Where?
From fucking Gladiator.
Show me where.
Let me see it.
That's that one, SPQR.
Oh, shit. The Roman, that's a Roman.
Yeah,
Roman
slave fucking Gladiator.
Tattoo, yeah.
He was so in love with this fucking performance.
I was
so
in love.
You know what?
No, don't make it bigger than what it is. I'm not in love
would
with anything.
Would you blow
anything.
Him?
No.
You wouldn't suck his dick?
No.
Real fast.
He won't come. You just put it in his mouth.
Oh, God. You're disgusting.
Just go one time down,
shut
one time
up. No.
Did you say that, though?
Not what did you say, Tim?
You wouldn't blow.
I didn't say no one.
Yes,
you
did.
Blow
I said some.
I was
said somebody from one of the new kids on the block or some crap like that. Yeah, you did. You mentioned one of them, but I can't remember which one
new
it was.
New kids on the block,
or one of those boy bands.
Yeah,
that,
why it would never be a boy band?
Oh yeah, you were at that time.
I was super gay at that time.
I don't know if you were gay or not, but you know that's what
you
like,
just. Oh, need, I want to fuck Joey's dick,
Tim. You just need to specify. He wouldn't blow the beautiful mind Russell Crowe, but the gladiator Russell Crowe.
Oh yeah, yeah. Would you? All right. Dad, let me rephrase the question. Would you blow?
I wouldn't blow anybody for any reason,
any
time.
Not even
no.
Real quick.
Would you put the tongue?
Nothing. No, I wouldn't even get near anything. No.
Well, if you had to blow a famous male actor,
I don't.
Or musician,
I'd shoot myself first.
All right. So shooting yourself is out of the question. You had to blow.
No, I am not going to say anything about any because see how 20 years later this shit keeps popping up.
It was even 20 years. Why are you
whatever?
It was
whatever
like,
it was.
It was
it
like
19
or 18 years.
Well, excuse me.
Okay. I mean, I'm scarred. I'm sorry.
You thought it was 2013, so
yeah, really, you don't even know.
I said 2013.
You really yeah, did. Said October 13, 2013.
Stupid.
Right. I didn't say that shit.
You did.
Oh yeah,
you did.
In the intro, you did.
No, I didn't. Everybody heard it. You guys are fucking high.
You said 2013.
The other one is high.
Well, I mean, but
it's recorded. We can listen back later.
Yeah, we can listen back later. That's fine. Because
I thought
I
you
said,
just said Friday the 13th.
I did. That's exactly what I said.
I heard 2013.
Then, no, said,
heard
then
Friday,
you said 2013.
Oh,
why would I say that?
Oh, my God.
I don't know.
You guys want to fuck with me?
Nobody's fucking
with
me.
I'm going to start putting
forward.
People's numbers in. Do you know there's this? All right. Let's. Just two more things I want to do right now.
There is.
All right. The first thing I want to do is. All right. Show motherfucking vote. You're in this room. That's a male. Who do you want to? Who's your male crush? Go ahead, Dad.
Adrian.
No, what the fuck?
Pretty damn close.
That's a good answer. Right?
That was good. Yeah. That was...
All right. Fuse.
You know, I just. I just really just don't have one. I'd love to be funny and just, you know, say something really funny,
right.
But I just don't have that. I just don't have that proclivity.
Proclivity. Wow.
Austin,
that's a big word.
Word of the day.
Because this will be held against me in the future.
Yes,
can
it
I
will.
Take the fifth?
And I'm going to write it
my
down.
My dad's awesome. Yep. And I envy my dad for being so awesome.
You
want to
cuddle your dad? Or?
I don't want to cuddle my dad. I'll give him a hug.
Oh, you said cuddle? No.
Yeah,
cup. I don't want to cut my father
some,
either.
This is some Florida shit right here. Yeah.
Did you say cuddle?
I would just
want to
you know, have sex with my dad.
The question was cuddle?
Yeah, cuddle.
Cuddle.
Yeah, cuddle a man. Like for warmth.
If I could meet Elvis, I'd give him a long hug.
Oh jeez.
No, like all right. Let's say that you're. Let's rephrase this question.
I'm a big Elvis fan.
You're in the woods. You only have you and another man.
You're an Elvis fan.
Who
I am an Elvis
hold?
Fan. That's how I got started in music.
Who do you want to hold? To
if
keep
you like any song I've ever written, if it wasn't for Elvis, that shit never would have happened.
Elvis is a mediocre singer, a piss poor actor, and I don't understand why anybody likes
him. And you want to blow Russell Crowe, so we're very different people.
Proclivity. Right.
Male crush?
Yeah.
Male hug?
Yeah. Crush.
Suck the dick. I mean, like, honestly, there's probably too many to name.
All right, we'll just leave it at that. No one else has anything except for Dennis. He's multiple game. Dennis just loves
one,
dick.
One, they're just... Fuck, I mean, Russell Crowe's already been named, right? Gladiator Russell Crowe.
You strike me as a Ryan Reynolds guy, maybe.
People say I look like Ryan Reynolds.
Honestly, probably just your dad that says that.
My dad?
No, his dad.
When you say
his
people...
Dad. What do you mean, people?
Did you, like, read that shit on a
forum? No. People tell me I either look like Russell Crowe or
you don't look like
Ben Affleck.
Russell Crowe?
Like drunk people?
Oh, not Russell Crowe. I mean, Ryan Reynolds.
Like drunk people or functional adults?
I'm actually, like Ryan almost, Reynolds I'm pretty much a celebrity around town, so you know how it goes. People see me, oh, you look like fucking Ryan Reynolds, and you look like Ben Affleck.
No drug one addicts, said that.
Yeah, yeah, people say that. People say that all the time. Bro, what about you? What guy do you want to cuddle?
My left hand?
Your left hand?
I'm not going to fucking cuddle no guy.
No.
Ah, don't.
No.
Stop being homophobic.
That's hetero.
Right.
No, seriously, no, no.
No?
No. But if I were to, like, want to be somebody, it would be Norman Reedus. I don't want to, like, date him or touch his penis or anything like that, but what? I would definitely.
Yeah, but if you were Norman Reedus, chances are you'd touch your own penis, probably.
Right.
No, chances
touché.
Are so high. Yeah.
Right, you like that wispy mustache look? You have to a couple times a day.
No, I just think he's fucking awesome.
Oh, okay.
He needs to wash his hair.
So do you.
No, I don't.
He doesn't even have hair.
He's fucking mustache.
You're very funny. Well, why are you giving me a hard time?
Why are you arguing with me?
Don't.
You just wanted to date me like 5 minutes ago. Don't start.
No, I had to throw
to
something
the
out there,
and
it had to
sandwich.
Be somebody
don't.
Other than a guy. No. So, you know.
Excuse me.
Anson. Hey, kids.
See, and I had all this time to think of a joke, too, and I got nothing for you.
You don't even got a guy that you want to cuddle with?
I don't know. I guess that dude from The Crying Game, because he kind of looked like a chick. That would
Who?
Probably be the closest I could come up with.
Huh. So there's only two guys that like guys in this room. All right. I don't have no one because I don't
liar.
I think like that.
You sure? No. Well, what was yours? Come on, Tim.
I don't do it.
You're a liar.
I want to cuddle myself.
I don't think so.
And girls. I'm super straight.
Yeah, right.
Super
but
straight.
But I am going to write a song about two people next week.
He doesn't have that proclivity.
Let's do it.
Somebody better look that up and make sure it was right. Cause
I already did it.
All right.
I just used it in a sentence. It's the word of the day.
So check this out.
Glad you like
I
it.
I got like this haunted phone number. It's Friday the 13th, so we should do some things, right?
No.
Yeah.
What do you mean do
For
some
sure.
things?
It's a haunted phone number. And they ask you like, all right, who's, do you want to make a cleaning appointment for somebody, right? And it's like code word for fuck with them. You know what I mean? Like, kill them.
What?
Yeah, it's a haunted phone number. You leave the number. And then they call back, and then they say, you have 5 days to live.
I love it.
Oh.
Wait, take my number one off me.
That would just piss me off.
Why is it not hearing?
You should call my old phone number from when I was a kid.
Is it not coming through?
Nope. Nothing. Nothing.
Here, I'm going to go over there. Do you have a mic? Does it work?
Yeah.
Do you have one of these plugins? For a phone?
No.
I have to go over there?
There's one right there, isn't there? Well, he's got it. He's using it.
Or push that one over here. Switch the one. Number one.
You want to take 13? Yeah. It's already kind of on that side.
And then bring it over here. How was your week, Dad?
It was all right.
What does that mean?
The week before was worse, but, you know, it was just... Your standard.
Yeah, what happened? Why are you no showing on a Friday?
I was
what
in.
A dick.
Didn't I call and tell you? I was in Marina no. Del Rey.
You texted me some bullshit. I can't understand because you don't know how to text.
Did
right?
you Uber somebody to the airport?
No, I took them to Marina Del Rey, which is a nightmare because there's so many cars down there. Traffic is bad.
Is that a lot of money?
Oh, I made like $125, I think.
Is that round trip from here?
No, it's just from here to there.
Okay. Oh, you don't get a round trip money.
Oh, no. Well, not unless somebody
well,
wants to come back
okay.
this way.
But it kind of figures in. It works out with fuel and your
yeah,
time
it,
and all that.
Yeah, it does. I mean, what, $10 worth of fuel?
So. All right, here it is.
Hello, Russell Crowe's office.
You have reached Booth World Industries. Your number has been logged and traced. A service representative will be with you shortly for remodeling. We at Booth World Industries say thanks. You have a marvelous day.
Hi, I have a friend who needs remodeling. I have a friend who needs remodeling. His number is 818-674-1066. Thank you very much, and have a nice day. All right.
Well, now we know whose number it is. Why do you have an 818 number?
He lives in the Valley.
Do you live in the Valley?
I've had an 818 number for...
Do you live in the Valley? You don't live in the Valley.
Right, no, yeah.
Do you really?
All right, Chris, if they call you back, you got to let us know, okay? You're going to get some remodeling, bro. What? There's nothing wrong with that.
I don't want everybody to have it.
They do now.
You don't want everyone to know your number is 818-674-1066?
That's the one, yeah.
Okay. We were already giving
you
your number.
I won't ever
away.
Say that again.
Way before that.
Missy, how was your week?
Interesting.
I know. Why are you putting all these naked pictures of yourself on the internet? You want all these guys to whack off to you or what?
If they want to.
do you like, is that your thing? Like, you're like a voyeur?
I'm just like, I own my sexuality, and if I feel sexy, I'll throw some sexy pictures.
Oh my god, that's so awesome. Like your voice, I just remember now. Okay, so you're like, oh, you one-upped it this week, huh?
With?
Like you only have like hearts, like pretend hearts on your nips?
Oh,
and
instead of the X's?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you can, if you look, you can almost see the outline of it.
Braver and braver, I'm pushing the limits.
And then what happened, like, 2 weeks ago, you got, like, super, like, emotional?
No, my car broke down. Like,
No. We're not talking about that shit. Let me
emotional.
Pull this up. All right, how was your week? Let's just talk about your week. We'll go there. We'll start with that.
Well, is my best friend's death day came up on the 5th of October. So I was going through that, but... That
sucks.
Was probably the emotional stuff. But
No.
And then writing. I've been writing a lot. So that kind of is
What
like,
do you write about?
You know, it's kind of all different. Like, I have a bunch of different things going on. So most of it's just, like, random stuff that's in my head. And I just, like, want to get it out. I haven't pieced it together.
It was, like, stories or something?
Well, I have one project that, yeah, it's a story based on true events. And, you know, the other stuff's just, like... You know, ideas for other projects. That's always the hardest part, is like finding a subject to write about.
Okay, I'm trying to pull up your shit.
There's a lot.
Hold on. None like this. Fuse, how was your week? Let's start there.
You know, I didn't really remember it, so I just looked at my calendar, and the week was fine. I took the day off on Tuesday and took Short Fuse to Underwood Farms, you know, me and D2. And he was supposed to go on this school field trip at some farm in Oxnard, and they sent home a waiver that said, this really long waiver about all the shit that could happen to your kid at this farm. Like, this farm is not a safe place, and this list of injuries that says, we are not responsible for all these things, and if your child dies, we are not responsible. They actually say, in case of death of your child, we are not, and I'm just not fucking signing this, so fuck you. And so I told Oz, and I said, you know, because Dee Dee showed it to me, you know, and she didn't like it either. And I said, no, fuck that. I said to Oz, look, you know what? I don't want you to go on this field trip because these people are, you know, this place sounds a little dangerous. I'm sure it's fine, but I said, instead, I'm going to take the day off and take you to Underwood Farms for the day, which he was really excited about. And so that's what we did. I took the day off, and we went to Underwood Farms. We spent like 5 hours.
So fun there, huh?
I love it, man. It was great.
Why didn't you just go on the field trip with him? At school.
Because so then, fuck then them. Fuck them and fuck their waiver. I don't want to sign it.
Why are you getting so worked up about a fucking waiver?
Fuck you.
I'm just wondering. You're getting super worked up about it.
He signed the waiver.
Well, just to go with them.
Why didn't you just go to where they said it was going to be and see if it was as bad as they say?
Because I don't give a I didn't give that much of a shit. Because I first
well,
of all,
I didn't get to hang out with the teachers too.
Really, the thing was is I didn't like the waiver. You know, I thought
so fuck the field trip, fuck your waiver.
I thought yeah, exactly. I'm not going to go to extra lengths. You know, I'm just not going to sign it. We're going to go do something else. You know,
yeah,
and I like Underwood Farms, and I was looking forward to it. It wasn't like it was a sacrifice. I love spending the day with Short Fuse. He's an awesome, awesome little kid. And he had such a great time, just so happy all day. And was raving about it the rest of the night. You know, boundless energy, that kid. So, no, it was a good decision. I'm glad we did it.
Man, it's always cool to take your kid out of school, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And spend personal time with them.
Yeah, you know, I just didn't agree with it. It's like, you know what, you have to take some some responsibility as a business to have some safety measures. You know, I thought the waiver just went too far, and I didn't like the wording. It just kind of bugged me, and I think it bugged some other parents. I heard through the grapevine it bugged a few people, and I know there was at least one other set of kids that didn't go. They did something else. So I thought it was a great idea. I don't regret it.
F and A. Right, I found your stuff.
Mine?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
September 29th, right? Over 80,000 children go missing in India every year.
Oh, yeah. I watched this really cool movie and I was all.
Was it a lion or something?
Yes!
You get like super like swerved just
yes.
by cinema, huh?
Yes.
Oh, everything. This is my favorite.
I let
one.
It consume me. Like.
Missy Lopez was seeking to make a difference in the world in Ventura, California. Everything seems so superficial and trivial now. Sometimes it takes something small to make an impact that changes our whole purpose in life. And then that's it. So what'd you do? You end up like joining the seminary or the missionary?
No, it was just like put things into perspective. Like I always worry about like superficial shit, like my hair and makeup and clothes and shit like that. And I just saw that movie and I was like, dude, they're so fucking poor, dude. Like I couldn't believe it. They worked like harder than fucking any fucking tweaker out here all day long for a little bag of milk. I'm like, what the fuck is that?
Just so overpopulated over there. That's why.
And then all the kids getting kidnapped, and like God knows what they're doing with all of them.
I know.
That's and they don't. They don't have waivers either.
You know, like that just like blew my head off.
So you're like, are you doing anything now, or is it just?
I don't
in
know
the
what to do. I wanted to like move
happy.
Over there and like build a little like
fuck?
Home for all those kids.
You would not make it back.
That's exactly what somebody told me. So I kind of just lost hope.
Fuse, can I ask you a question?
No.
And if you don't like what's coming out of my mouth, just say move on.
Okay.
Without you getting upset?
He's still pissed
off. I'm not
going to
get upset. No, me being upset is my normal thing. Like when I was in high school and I flirt with girls, they thought I like hated them and I wanted to kill them because apparently I didn't look at them or I didn't like flirt the right way. I come across as angry. It's just I'm actually really happy and in a good mood right now.
Okay. Don't seem like it.
So Jeez. Here's my question for you. do you know anything about Freemasons?
Yes, I do.
What do you know?
They're free and they do masonry work.
It's the dumbest shit I ever heard, Phil. Go back to sleep.
Oh, it couldn't be the dumbest thing you ever heard.
Well, I know that it's the oldest fraternity in the world. And it's not a secret society. It's a society with secrets. Because if you're a Freemason, you can be open about it, as I am. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if that was your next question, but I am a Freemason. Of course, it was a bad time to ask after I was cursing my face off just now. I said the F word like six times talking about waivers.
And
you know, and that's not generally you know how we conduct ourselves. You know, but it's a fraternity. It's an ancient fraternity. And again, not a secret society, but a society with secrets.
And see, right, so the reason why I'm asking you this is because I'm looking for answers right now in
okay.
my life.
Okay.
humans. Like, why? What are we? Why are we here? Mm-hmm. Who put us here? You know what I mean?
Right.
I'm not trying to offend anybody, but I'm not gonna buy into the whole Jesus shit. It's too easy. That's too much. That's
Excuse me. Can we stop the war on the Judeo-Christian culture, please?
No one's saying nothing.
You know what?
Specifically.
You know what, Tim? Merry Christmas.
Oh, you're not either. You're not either. Stop it.
I'm just having fun.
Okay, I was like tripping. I thought you were frills. All right.
You're like a girl in his school.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is that why you looked in that direction?
You know, I was early on, I was kind of drawn to it, you know, by the mystery of it. I mean, we're all drawn to mystery, I think. You know, which is why you hear about all this Illuminati bullshit that everybody buys into that's absolute crap.
You don't think that shit's real?
No, it's not.
Have you ever heard of the Illuminati card game?
You asked me that the other day, and I told you no, and I still haven't because I didn't even bother to Google it after you told me.
Well, you asked me what is it, and I just ignored it.
Oh, yeah, I don't even remember talking to you, except for I remember you asking me that, but I remember you didn't, you know. If you don't answer me, I just forget we're even texting. And so... Well, but first I was drawn to the mystery of it, but also I discovered that I actually knew a couple of Freemasons, and these were people I respected. These were people that I thought were very, very good men, and that they were kind of leaders, you know, and good examples of people. And so it drew my interest.
Is there secrets? I'm not gonna ask what they are, but
you can
is
ask.
It in the direction of who we are? The answers I'm looking for, or do you think that's sort of just like a cover? Like that's not for reals.
No, you're not this. Whatever anything you're gonna hear from a Freemason isn't going to be a cover or a lie. There's just really, really no point in doing that. The one of the things you might read is, you know, the Freemasons will take good men and make them better. Make them better men. Teach them how to be better men.
I don't even have time to be a better man.
You know, and you are a good man. You are a good man. And most of the stuff I probably wouldn't discuss on the air.
Okay.
But you can ask. I'm happy to answer any questions I can. This doesn't bother me at all. This doesn't bother me. I think the Freemasons is a great organization. There are some people that think, I have a family member who thinks that we're foot soldiers for Satan, you know, and that I'm involved in some grand plan of evil that I am not aware of because I'm too low in the organization. And none of those things are true.
Ansel, what do you know about it?
What, about Freemasonry?
Yeah. Because I know sometimes you get stuck on something and just do a lot of research on it.
Pretty much everything that Fuse just told you is what I've discovered. My father was a Freemason, and my grandfather was also a Freemason.
They take black people?
Yeah. They take black people.
Yes.
I wasn't sure. I thought that you guys were eliminated. Whoa.
Freemasons. Amazing. That's one of the things I love about Freemasons. Is
fucking amazing.
You're not going to hear about. You're not going to be hearing arguments on religion. You're not going to be hearing arguments on political arguments. It's not about your religion or the color of your skin. You know, and
idiot dad.
Yeah, it's all colors and creeds.
I don't know, man. I haven't seen.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
So let me ask you.
Go
ahead. He's just going to say something.
He has something written down.
No, there's a lot of there's a lot of men of color in that are Freemasons that are absolutely the absolutely Freemasons and are the best people that I know. What's your question?
Okay, do you wear a funny hat, like maybe
a fez?
A fez or something like that?
No, that's Shriners.
Well, you know.
But I'm not a Shriner. I don't have time for it. I could if I wanted. In order to be a Shriner, you have to be a Freemason first.
What the fuck is a Shriner now?
That's the Shriners are an appended body to Freemasons. You have to be a third-degree Freemason to join the Shriners. And basically, the Shriners are all about having fun. And they're like kind of the lighter side of Masonry, and they do a lot of
charity
work.
Yeah, they drive clown cars and have a good old time.
Yeah, they you know, like the, is it the Children's Hospital or mm-hmm. St. Jude's? Yep. You know, they do, they
tons.
Yeah, they do all the funding for that. So they do a lot of charity work.
Brian, how was your week?
And there's no secret handshake or anything like that? So when you're a Mason, do you get out of being a Mason?
Dad, are you thinking and, like and go, the Flintstones?
And go on up there to be a Shriner, but you first have to do a whole lot of brick work and concrete work and things like that, masonry work, stuff like that. Is that
an operative Mason.
Oh.
Who is
or general contractor.
Working as a Mason.
Or Mexican,
Freemason. You can be a Mexican Freemason.
No, I don't think so.
Freemasons are in every country.
How was your day?
I just don't believe that.
Or a week.
You don't believe that?
My week was very busy.
You just work?
Can I just say one thing to your dad, though? Everywhere. I can go anywhere in the world and have backup.
Well, everybody's got concrete and bricks.
It's like the Hell's Angels.
He's the Hell's Angels of the cloth. Power of Christ compels you, motherfucker. Hey, who loved Jesus in this motherfucker?
I was stuck with a bunch of old people.
Oh, jeez.
Freemasons?
Freemasons.
I did a class reunion 50.
Hanging out with Phil?
I did my photo booth, and these people were like stuck in the 60s. Didn't know what to do. Didn't know what a computer was. Like,
wait a minute. These people were in their 50s, you said?
No, they were stuck in the 60s.
But no, before that.
50th
did you say
year.
It was a 50 year
oh,
reunion.
50 year re- oh, 50th. What?
1967. 50th
reunion. Were they like all surprised by what was there? My fuck. This. What is this?
Yeah.
Is this a cell phone?
They were like really.
Cellular?
And they didn't want to touch the computer or the monitor like you're supposed to. So I was only there for an hour, then my nephew got stuck with him.
So what kind of music did you play?
Music?
Oh, I thought you went there to do music.
I did a photo booth.
Oh, okay.
And then I had to go set up another photo booth in Santa Paula with a whole bunch of little kids where the parents, I don't know, they were busy doing something.
You said Santa Paula, I know.
Yeah. And
I know.
Bunch of little kids tearing shit up. And after I went back to pick up my nephew, then he got stuck with him again while I went to go do a yacht party.
Fucking bitching. Happy birthday, fucking Chris Austin.
Well, thank you, brother. That was my week.
How old are you?
45.
Liar.
It's pretty good.
Tim said you were 55.
But you missed Hug a Drummer Day.
What's that?
You missed Hug a Drummer Day.
I did, yeah. I didn't really get many hugs on Hug a Drummer Day. It was kind of a bummer.
No hand
hugs. That was on the 10th.
Oh, so you were a National Coming Out Day.
I know about it, Dennis, from your post. Thank you.
Wait, what?
If you need a hug, I'm sure there are plenty of people here that are willing to give you
right,
one.
Right, I know. I'm good now, though. Actually, after the fact, I'm good. I got plenty of hugs. And it was my birthday, so I got plenty of hugs and went out with my daughter and spent a good day with her. Had some sushi and went to the bakeries and got pastries. And
where'd you go to sushi?
We went to, it's right across the street from the Big Lots there on right by Seaward. I don't know the name of it.
It's not the sushi house.
No.
No, that's not okay.
Oh, it's
no.
The one.
You know, we tried to go to the sushi house. It was over on Seaward.
Oh, yeah. What's the name?
We tried to go to the one off Seaward, but it's all closed.
It's right across the street from Lee's Chinese.
Oh, well, it's closed during the they closed.
Like, no, it's like it's boarded up and there's tape on the windows.
What?
Yeah. So it's right up like Main and Seaward, right there on the corner.
Down there by the beach, right?
No, not by the beach. Up higher.
Oh, yeah, that
side.
One. Okay.
By the gas station.
Yeah, that one's gone. So, so the sushi place we went to, yeah. So when I went to that sushi house, that one was closed, and that's when I, you know, I'm like, all right, let's go to this. Nope. So then I looked it up on the phone, and I'm over by Smart and Final, and I'm like, oh, it's like right there. It's like two doors down from Smart and Final.
Yeah.
And then there's that Rosabella's Bakery right across the street. Then I went in there, and I'm looking for German chocolate cake, but it's a Mexican bakery. Yeah. And they didn't have that. So we ended up with like two full trays of bread and cookies and everything, and I spent like $4.
Yeah.
And it was rad. So that was a...
Like that Mexican bread stuff that's really colorful and looks amazing but tastes like
nothing.
Tastes
like crap.
My daughter got those. But I got most of the things that I got were like the like churro type things.
It's like you go to Willy Wonka's and everything tastes like chicken.
You know, but they did have like these, like, you know, about the size of a dinner plate. It was like a churro, like a flat churro size of a dinner plate. It was fantastic. Their breads there were amazing. It was like 50 cents a roll for this, like the size of your head.
Nice.
So we bought a lot of bread and rolls and cinnamon things. Yeah. Yeah. And
they're cheap head is good. I mean, cheap bread is good.
Cheap head is always good.
All right.
Right. Massage parlors and beyond.
And you're going to Vegas tomorrow?
Going to Vegas tomorrow. Yeah, I was supposed to go tonight. So
you're leaving with K&S?
I'm going to actually go out with K&S, yeah, because I need to go pick up an RV, and I didn't feel like driving and leaving a car there. And so I'm going to go pick up my RV. And so the ride that I was supposed to have, they were sick, and so they weren't going out. That's and I already had plans to go out there. And so I'm like, shit. So I saw a post that Ki did, and he's like, I'm going to Vegas tomorrow. I'm like, shit, I need a ride. And I didn't feel like flying and wasting more gas and leaving a car, like I said. So, yeah, so I'm going out with Ki tomorrow, he and his brother.
Well, happy motherfucking birthday, man.
Right? Yeah, I'll do some partying in Vegas as well.
Dennis, what up?
Yo.
Remember last week you were all sad and shit?
I mean, I think I was more angry. You know, like,
I'm mad. Hey, fuck this. I'm not going to come to the show. You guys.
I was having a little fit, you know?
He was pissed off when I first got here today. And he was
why?
Because
I wasn't here. You're pissed.
He was just pissed.
Did I miss that? Was that later? Was that later in the night?
I've seen him only happy today.
I mean, got new weed, so it's working pretty good. But I don't know. What's up, guys? What's up?
What's up, man? How are you?
I was looking at me. I forgot why.
How was your week?
You get laid?
Oh yeah, he said earlier. No. He'll tell you.
I saw you Tuesday at Copper Blues.
I saw Chris Austin Tuesday at Levity Live, and
right.
And that we had a show there, Levity Live. Wednesday I had the normal every Wednesday show. Thursday was first softball game of the season.
When's the last time you got laid?
Wow, that sucks. Are you kidding?
I think last night.
Trying to figure out who's listening right now that's going to burn him out.
2013?
I'll buy that.
Liar.
What did you tell me? What did you tell me when you first got here today?
I don't know.
You're just liar.
I was in a character.
Like, hey, do you want
I do know what I said, but I was just like messing around. I was setting up the drums, and I just like, fuck, man, just a bunch of bitches, dude. And I don't know what I don't know exactly like how it came out, like word for word, but I walked in.
Let
like,
me tell you. I think I got her pregnant last night.
No. I know what I said. I think I got two out of three of them pregnant. That's what I said.
Or one out of two.
I said two out of three. I remember.
Oh, okay.
You sparked
my
memory.
See, now your mom's listening. She's going to get all freaked out again.
So now that joke might be true, the one that we told when you first started.
If his mom listens to this show, it doesn't matter what he says.
She's going
to
learn.
She's going to learn what?
I ain't baby no more.
Yeah, was she freaked
out?
No,
you baby daddy now.
Ooh, yeah. Well, hopefully not baby daddy.
Give me your money
for
the next 18 years.
Oh, call me daddy.
All right. Bro, what up? How was your week?
Interesting. You know, got.
Uh-oh.
Where do you pick up hoes from? That's why I'm curious. Like, do you go on, like, is there a dating app?
I'm in a relationship.
Yeah, no, I know, but when you were...
Yeah, you're going to get her in trouble again. You already got her in trouble last time.
Yeah, but where do you get the hoes at?
Yeah, where the hoes at?
It ain't the kind of hoe that you
know?
Want.
They're all gay anyways.
Yeah, where she gets hoes ain't going to be where you get hoes.
Yeah, really.
No, where do you get it? Because all your girlfriends are real hot.
All my... I only have one girlfriend.
Yeah. She's hot.
What? And you've never seen her, so how do you know?
Social media is stupid.
Oh, okay.
Wait, you have Russell Crowe on the brain or what?
No, yeah. I'm just wondering.
No, I'm good where I'm at.
Where'd you meet her?
My girlfriend?
Yeah.
Where everyone meets?
Tinder?
No.
Church?
Fuck no.
Tavern?
Church?
Your sister?
No. No. My what?
ChristianMingle.com?
Yes.
Oh,
that's where I met my band members.
Yeah, that's where I met her.
I was hoping.
No, actually, we didn't reunion. Even want ever to admit this, but we actually met off POF.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I was hoping you said
that. But I wasn't actually looking for anything, and neither
Bull
was
crap.
She. No,
yeah,
seriously.
If you're on POF, you're looking.
Yeah.
No, I wasn't. I was actually
now you're just like a fish in an aquarium.
Are you really one to talk right now?
Right, okay.
I haven't been late since 2013. I get late on the daily. So shut up.
I mean, okay.
Wow. Gee, got a point.
Yeah, no. I've had an interesting week though. I got a tattoo on Tuesday.
Of what?
It's Tattoo more Tuesday. Gay shit, you know.
What, like a it? Rainbow or? Rainbow
well, yeah, play? Two rainbow stars and like four.
Some kind
other
of abstract
ones.
Thing.
Like, how many times are you gonna tell people you're gay with these tattoos, Adrian?
Do you see people how gay they are?
Yeah, people understand you're gay.
Which is what? No.
You don't need to look at your tattoos and tell you're gay.
Yeah, really. All I gotta do is watch, see you walking down the street.
Are you really one to talk? Don't even start right now, motherfucker. Don't.
I thought it was Jose don't, Smash when
don't
I walked
be
in.
Be nice.
I won't.
It's gonna be a chair for
be nice.
I swear to God.
I'll come up with some nice
I swear to Allah, don't. Don't start your shit right now.
What? Did you
don't,
just say?
Don't feel. Don't.
Straight out Indian right there.
Uh-oh. See, I changed
hey,
that too.
Hey, you better stop. Missy's going to start crying. Kids. India. Someone watch her Facebook for me.
She's going to start writing right now. But I got evacuated from work today.
You got what?
Evacuated oh, yeah, from work. Yeah, because of the whole... I don't even, the double homicide suspect or something like yeah. that. You know, my work is right behind.
Did they really catch that fool in...
In Inglewood.
Yeah, they found yeah. him in Inglewood.
What happened?
What the fuck were they doing over here?
Well, according to Facebook what? News, you know, they said that...
It's always true.
Yeah. If it's not on Facebook, it's not real. But according to that, they said that, you know, a friend of his, like, called the police, and I guess he evaded the police before
oh,
he even
dude's
got
the
there.
Man.
Yeah, before, I guess, at some point, so they were staking out the house, and they had, like, snipers on top of the bell tower.
Where? Out here?
In Ventura.
Yeah, in Ventura, like,
yeah,
right
the St. Bonaventure, they were, like, right above it. Like
that's crazy.
There.
I saw all the helicopters, actually.
Yeah,
I was down at the beach earlier today and saw all the hovering helicopters.
Yeah, I was, like,
yeah,
at ground
he was in
zero,
Inglewood
though.
Watching that shit on TV.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
Check it out!
Dumbass.
As I'm over here, ground zero, I'm like, okay, if he gets shot, just bring him to the mortuary. We got
yeah, a
it.
Lot of places were on lockdown. There, I had a friend who got locked down at work. He works. It was right across the street from fuck VCMC, God. The hospital.
Yeah, I was at the funeral home. That's where I work.
Okay, yeah, yeah. So that area right there, there's people at a
yeah, they had
oh, right
to
up Mills and all that.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah.
It was like Loma Vista.
Okay. Loma Vista, Loma Vista,
that's
Hillmont,
CMH. That's
Hillmont,
whole,
that
yeah,
area.
The whole area.
Yeah, CMH and VCMC. Yep.
I mean, they lock down Hillmont all the time, so it's like
Hillmont.
Really no big deal.
Didn't I say Hillmont?
Yeah, it was Hillmont and Loma Vista, like that yeah. area. They were starting to evacuate us like about 2 or 3, and then like, no, about 3:30, and then we got a call saying, you know, that
all
they
clear.
Caught the guy in Inglewood, and we're just like, that was pretty pointless.
Thanks.
But then again,
thanks. This is Ventura.
Then again, I got to go home early, so it's okay. But that was pretty much like the highlight of my week, though.
Still, it's easy to see why they're hyper on it, though. I mean, it's it makes true. Sense.
Yeah, I mean, nothing really happens here, so they were, like, on it. And but I did see all the news feeds, and they're like, quiet town of Ventura. I'm like, motherfuckers, you lie.
Ansel, how was your week?
Well, it was all right. You know, nah, I watched a bunch of flat earth videos. And hey, I'm yeah. with you, Fuse. You know, fuck those motherfuckers. Don't sign that shit. Fuck them.
Thank you.
Fuck them.
Thank you.
What's that got to do with your week?
Rock and roll.
That was like an hour ago.
That was just yeah. a comment that I felt.
No,
like
I appreciate
adding.
That. Just don't listen to Phil at all ever, and thank you.
I never do anyway.
So you're still onto the flat earth thing?
Yeah, man. I get a kick out of that shit.
Have you found any evidence to support either way?
What?
Well, no. I found evidence.
Get him. Get him, bro. Get him.
Dude, the sun's
but I get flat. I get a kick out of watching the videos because it's entertaining.
What do you, hey, bro, number two.
Yeah,
this guy's trying to make fun of you because you believe a certain way.
Flat earth, are you kidding me?
Wait, Dennis is a flat earth guy?
Not really, but he'll say that he is just to piss you off.
That's what I would think.
Yeah. Dennis, why are they trying to start pestering you right now?
First, the sun's not flat. Now the earth's not flat. What's next? It's flat. It's all flat.
Okay.
It's like a cone, bro.
Have you ever read Flatland? You should read Flatland.
Tell them about the periscope,
bro. I don't
bro.
Read. I just see with my
you
eyes.
You can get it on Audible and listen to it.
Yeah, you don't have to, like, read anything.
You don't have to know how to read.
Just listen. Yeah.
You guys are stressed
you
me
can
out.
Listen.
Stressed out right now. All right. Let's. Sylvie, how are you? Come over here. Sit where Chris Austin was sitting. Fuck that guy.
Yeah. And maybe you could tell him your last name so that he can.
Because Chris is a little boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, when he sits down, he's 5'6" wow. of power.
She knows how to work a mic stand.
Chris still uses a high chair, so, you know.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Good, I'm good.
You're from
Germany.
Germany originally.
And my last name is Mietzekatze.
Oh,
it's totally made up.
Can you spell it?
Is it really?
Yeah, it's fake. No, it means pussycat in German. In German.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
How did you make your journey to Ventura of all places?
To Ventura?
Probably an airplane.
Oh, yeah, duh.
Yeah.
Idiots.
I think somebody roofied me and then I woke up the next day, had no clothes, and then over in it was in the USA all of a sudden.
And so you just decided to stay?
No, you mean how I came from Germany?
Yes.
Yeah, that's no, I'm actually very boring story. It has to do with
can't be any worse than the last one.
Ex-husband and all that stuff.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah.
You were in a band at one point?
Yeah, I had a band in Germany. I had a couple band. I had one band that had my first band. I can swear, you guys are swearing,
yes.
Right?
Fuck no.
Fuck.
Can no.
Okay, I had when I was 13 years old, I had a band called Fistfuck.
Uh-huh.
Whoa,
good band name.
We were
was it in German? Did you say it in German or was it in English?
No, it was in English because Fistfuck in German doesn't really. Actually, they use the English.
I want to go to Germany now so I can just say that to everybody.
Guten Tag, Fistfuck.
They might know what you mean. But the thing is, we practiced in a church basement and they didn't know what that meant. So that was our very first band.
Oh, that's
awesome. That's she's so punk rock. She is.
Did you play that song with the 100 Red Balloons or something like that?
Oh, actually, we cover that in my new band.
I think it's 99.
That's Nina. Nina is a little older than me.
I know. I was just trying to see what.
He's trying to be funny. See how it didn't work?
Good. That's very good. You know your Germans.
Crash and burn.
You know, it's better than talking about Adolf Hitler and all this. This is what comes to mind when people think about Germans, you know. They think about Lederhosen.
My mom's maiden name is German. Schnapp?
Schnapps?
Yeah.
That Schnapp. Means liquor.
No, no. What? S. No S. Okay. Just Schnapp.
Schnapp.
Yeah.
Schnapp. Yeah. That means like catching?
Oh. Okay.
Schnapp, Schnapp.
Mm-hmm.
That's okay, cool.
They caught you, huh, Dad? They caught the catch of a lifetime.
Is it different with the S? Does it mean something different with the S?
That means liquor.
Oh, okay, well.
So that's a big difference.
Schnapps means liquor.
Yeah.
That's good, yeah.
There's all different kinds, like peach and peppermint.
Yeah, the Germans do like their schnapps. My dad makes his own schnapps, actually. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He makes a honey schnapps over there.
Well, you're a writer for No Cover.
Yes,
and you do a killer job.
Thank you.
Super impressed. Like the first article I read of yours, I was like, oh my God.
She wrote for a punk rock magazine in Germany.
Yes, that's what she was telling me.
Yeah, it was called The Plastic Bomb, and we had the girl part of it, and we interviewed all kinds of bands, either from America or that one time we had somebody from Japan, but they didn't speak English or German, so I just made everything up.
Is it English spoken in Germany quite frequently?
Germans have to learn English.
Oh, they do.
And oftentimes they pretend like they cannot speak it, but they all have to learn it. So if you see a German and they tell you they can't speak English, it's a lie.
That's just kind of a like fuck you thing.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah. Well, they're oftentimes embarrassed, but buy them some schnapps, some drinks, and they will speak any language.
How long have you been here?
Wow. 16 years.
16 years, huh?
Yeah.
How does the music scene compare in Germany to Ventura?
Actually in Germany we had many like youth centers where you get food, you get gas money, you know, they really, the government puts a lot of money in these institutions and you can play there as a band. Touring in Europe is great because they hook you up with everything. And when you know, that's the reason why we started a band. Just so we can go from town to town and drink for free and, you know.
That's awesome.
That is freaking awesome.
That's the reason to play music, right? Yeah.
So United States isn't the best?
I don't know. It's up to you, though.
Actually, you know, now coming back to Germany, it changed a lot after 16 years. Many, many rules that they have. And we have also...
it's gotten more conservative, right?
Yes.
There seems to be a little bit of a movement
there
that way.
There is some stuff going on in Germany that is a little frightening right now, but yeah.
They got to make Germany great again.
Yes.
Looks like Germany needs some freedom to me.
We had some frightening stuff here, too, but you're here for that.
Yeah.
And you know.
Yes. But I try to have fun. I don't think about all the sad things, you know. Otherwise,
Mike.
I cry in my pillow at night.
Yeah, Mike, Chris.
And Fuse, you too. Both of you guys, idiots. See how I played that one off?
Yeah, stupid.
So you're also in a band?
Yes.
Of a couple, maybe, I heard?
Well, I have an all-girl band called the Shady Ladies. Right now we are on hiatus. We're looking for a guitar player. Our guitar player left. She didn't want to be there anymore with us. But so right now we're just kind of taking a break. But I have a new band with there's a band in Santa Barbara called the Devereaux. Uh-huh. They're really awesome. You should have them on the show.
Yeah, they're good. They are
they're
good.
Really good. They're really good. They're like Ramones, the Queers kind of band.
Yeah.
And they took me in there kind of because I was a rock and roll orphan. So they let me cover a couple songs with them. And so now we decided to start a new band called Uber Death.
Uber Death.
Uber Death, yes.
What does Uber mean?
Uber means over. But,
over?
Yeah.
Super?
Super, but it can mean super. And then, of course, I drive Uber. Do you drive Uber? I heard. Is that right?
How'd you find that out?
I heard that.
Oh, right. Okay.
I pay attention. Right. That's what we learn in Germany, yeah.
So you do that too?
I do that too. I drive Uber and Lyft. And it's just a little creepy, I think. Do you have a lot of creepy people come to your...
No, actually, they're pretty nice.
He's
people.
The creepy one.
Yeah, Phil's the biggest
I think everyone
in the car.
Is going to say
because
that.
Because they get in his car and don't try to get
they
to
get
know
out,
him. But
they get
in your
like,
car, they want to get to know you.
Boy, that was creepy.
Yeah.
You get your weirdos.
She's the only
sometimes.
Uber driver that says the word Uber correctly, by the
Uber.
Way.
Yeah, Uber. But there's a lot of drunk college kids in Santa Barbara, and they... Yeah, no, it's pretty gnarly when you drive Uber. But, yeah, it means super death. It actually has nothing to do with it. It's kind of funny, I think, you know, Uber death. And I'm not sure if I should advertise that, you know, having people in my car.
It just sounds cool, though.
Right? Uber death.
Yeah.
Oh. But, but we're playing...
I'll take the ride.
On the 28th, is the Halloween weekend, at Skip Gibson's Barbecue and it's like Grover... Or
that's Grover's Beach.
Grover Beach.
Yeah,
know,
Grover
so, yeah.
Beach. Is that
one
a Chris Sandoval show, Guardsman Productions? Yeah.
With the Bitch Fits.
Oh, that'll be a cool show.
All-girl Misfits cover band. And yeah.
That's awesome.
She rocks, man. Two of my bands have played with two of her previous bands. Hard Six and another band I was in, F6. We played with, when you were in Silent Meow, way back in the day, we played at the sewer. And then, oh, I forgot the other one. Oh, both bands played with Silent Meow, I guess, or
yeah,
same show.
You guys played at Whiskey Richards.
Yeah, Whiskey Richards and in the sewer, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she rocks.
Freaking
it's fun. It's just fun to walk around, poke people. What usually happens is that I have my microphone cord and people try to stay away from me. You know, there's always like, there's nobody in front of the stage because I like to go there, up there. And poke them and dance with them. Oh, I think that's the thing. It's the experience.
You got to come on. You should bring your band. Anytime.
It's very fun.
Open invitation.
I just like to play music. That's
all right. Well, this is Red Light Dish Show. This is Sylvie. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Check out Nuno cover with Welshly Arms on the cover. Welshly Arms is now featured on a WWE pay-per-view. They were, you know, just had a song on the radio. Not even... on XMU, and then they just rolled out of control, and now over 20 million people are hearing their song to play up a WWE pay-per-view. Welshly Arms, check them out. The song is legendary. Remember, I played it a few weeks back about our music community. Well, this is a Red Light Dish Show. We'll be right back with Jelly. Ladies and gentlemen, the Jelly!
If I don't win today. song is called Desire. This next one's called Bridge Under the River Kwai.
The families to live unchained, for those in distress, searching for a better way, for those who do remember, remember the river quiet. Yearning for lost places brings pain. Sacrifice. No way out now, and no way home. Love shall ring out forevermore. Those who do remember, remember the river. Yearning for lost places brings pain, sacrifice.
What's going on?
Thank you.
What's up? What's up?
How are you guys?
We're fantastic.
Thank you guys so much for coming through.
Yeah,
absolutely. Thanks for having us.
You guys missed your award, but I think you guys got it.
We got our award. Where is it, though? Hold it up for
there it
everyone
is.
Not to be able to see.
That's a special award. You see that?
Yeah.
It is special.
The normal ones come like this.
Uh-oh.
That means somebody in the family noticed how great you guys are and are becoming. You know, you guys, a lot of times, you know, not all the time our art is appreciated, you know, and we don't want you guys to give up. You guys make beautiful sounds,
thank
beautiful
you very
music.
Much. We're happy to be, you know, even recognized, but great to even be here, and then great to have an award. I mean, what can you say? Can't ask for anything more.
Yeah,
oh yeah, yeah! Great job at assembling all that together. That was
man, that was a
pretty impressive.
Pain in the dick.
And we had fun. We made sure to have a good time.
We start working on that shit in January, so oh, the break is about to be done.
I didn't make one mistake.
Your mistakes were my mistakes, bro. Honestly, that was the truth.
I don't remember. Were there any mistakes?
Oh, dude.
Fuck.
I started the snowball effect. I had no idea.
We had Michelle Coltrane on the other room, and he was like, yeah, fucking play metal. Go for it. And so there's two different performances going on, and people like are watching the screen and hearing the music while two music.
Well,
people were banging their head to Coltrane, you know?
It was a timing issue. They started on time. We started late. And so when they started on time, we had our first act go on. And
well, I can't remember anything at all going wrong. Seemed to me like it was perfect.
That's all behind the scenes.
No, it was very impressive.
PR.
And I've said this before, watching Tim up there on stage, talking into that one silent mic, telling everybody what to do, and emceeing at the same time. I've never seen that in my life. So, dude, you need to delegate.
Yeah,
yeah, it was packed. It was packed.
We're gonna
it
need
was
you.
The event. The event of 2017.
We sold out a lot of their food as well.
Awesome.
Nice.
Like we leveled that place. It was the first time they've ever been like wall to wall just busy.
They had to cancel the show on Monday, if I'm not mistaken, because they didn't have enough food. Or they closed the place because they didn't have enough food for the next day.
Yeah, we were supposed to play like the following couple days, and they're like, no.
They had funny.
What'd they tell you guys?
They made up some excuse.
No, that was actually true. Actually, because I was there. I was actually there, and after
he's the one that caused the pipe to burst.
I dropped a deuce. My bad. And yep. Blame red light.
Victory deuce.
Blame red light. It's their fault, bastards.
So how long have you guys been doing this?
We've been together for about 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah. Going strong. Brittany has been with us for 2.5, the majority of all of us.
2 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I remember when she first joined, she was super excited. She was like, you know the jelly? I was like, yeah. She was like, guess what? I'm going to sing with them, I think. I was like, oh.
Well,
and
you know,
she got it.
Jeremiah was like, I found this chick. Ooh, whoops. He's like, I found this girl.
I know, we met at open mic night at the sewer, and I was like, I had to play music with this guy because he's the best drummer.
Just pipes too, huh?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, everyone loves her. It's great.
So how did you not end up? How'd you end up getting that award late? Did you leave? What happened?
We left because there wasn't enough seats. Is that all the seats were taken? And like we had to kind of. When they left, I got a table, and then they left, so I was like, I don't know what to do. Like, I felt bad for taking up those seats because everything was full, and yeah, that's why we...
There were, mothers and pregnant women that
yeah,
wanted
we were
seats,
like,
so we gave up our seats.
Yeah.
And then, you know, there was just... There's just
so that's
too
right,
many
you had an entire hand
show.
You had an entire handmade section, right?
Rough
behind us, and that's why I was like, well, I feel bad for taking these seats.
And there's a time where they didn't let no one in that theater.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It was awesome. And then, like, over on the other
well,
side.
Well, meaning it was a not awesome that you had difficulties, but it's a quality problem. You throw a music event in Ventura, and everybody and their dog shows up. know, and it's packed, and they have to turn people away. Well, that's a success.
Yeah, I was. That's what I was worried about the most. I was like, no one's gonna show the fuck up. Who gives a fuck? You know
what I mean? Everybody showed, and it was prestigious.
All music styles, which was sweet too.
We're gonna take it back there.
It's amazing.
It's probably gonna be Saturday, September 9th, is what we're. What we're negotiating at the time.
Thank you for a Saturday because that makes life a whole lot easier.
I know. I'm pretty sure we'll get a lot more people, too.
That Sunday-Monday thing kicked my ass, so.
You mean next year you're talking about?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, not 18. This September.
18.
Oh, wait, never mind. Yeah, this September. Now.
Oh. Yeah, this September for you.
September's over.
I've been doing things like that lately. I'm very confused about where I am, what I did, and what month it is.
Me, too. Me, too.
I don't know if it's age. No. But I know that it's 2017 because Tim said it was 2013.
Also, Kevin Costner is on the bill for that night. So we've already made that deal back in August. So that's just.
The Kevin Costner. Our moms will be happy.
Yeah. But wouldn't it be awesome to see the motherfucking dude from Waterworld?
Hell yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I want to check behind his ears if he has.
Il Postino.
Oh, yeah, because his manager owned it, right? Hartley?
Hartley, yeah. Mark Hartley.
Yeah, so. All right. So let's start, like, what was the infant idea behind the creation?
Well, this a lot of the original ideas came from a band that Jeremiah and I had played in first, and that was my first band, and his, like, 75th band that he's played in. And it was an instrumental, like, jazz type band, and they're all free from ideas. And then we decided, let's hone this in, let's tighten it up, and get some good people on board. And then we brought on Brandon, who's our bass player, who's unfortunately not here with us. He's in Joshua Tree.
Desert Days.
Shout out to Iggy Pop. And then, you know, everything came together really when Brittany joined, and everything tightened up, and we've been on the road to where we should have been with Brittany at the front. It's great.
Oh, you guys are killer.
Oh, that's so cute.
I thought for sure Jeremiah was gonna punch my face when the music award thing fiasco happened. I was like, he's gonna blame me because you're a hothead, bro. Like, I don't know you. I just watch your interactions on social media, and I see you as a hothead. I was like, this motherfucker, when he sees me, he's gonna hit me.
No,
he's fine.
No.
He's cool. Collected.
Serious? Okay. Yeah.
If he puts extra exclamation points, like, don't be deterred. That's just how he speaks.
And if he uses emojis, then you should be scared.
But I'll tell you what, you are one persistent motherfucker, for sure, yeah. When it comes to tech. Hey, can I get my award? He just wanted to hold it, I think.
Thank you.
He got it. You are.
Jeremiah, I told you so many times. Come on. You're like, okay, I'll be there.
Yeah,
no.
But I don't drive right now, so it'll be a long walk.
Yeah, that was sick, so I don't want to
do it. What do you guys got coming down in the future for the jelly?
Playing,
We are playing, we're opening for the Motels at the Canyon Club.
I think I have some tickets.
October 22nd.
Nice.
That's pretty solid right there. That's a good gig.
Yeah, Martha Davis. She's amazing. I really am so excited to, like, open
her
up
mom
her.
Is flying out from Hawaii.
Yeah,
just
my
for
mom
the show.
Is flying
serious?
All the way out from
she's
Hawaii
a legend.
To see the show.
Tammy, you're a legend.
I know. I love my mom so much. She's so supportive. Like, who would do that?
Well, not me.
No.
Moms.
And they're like $500 round trip.
She got miles.
Oh, she does. So.
She got miles.
Mom's got miles.
Well, that helps.
Mom's got miles. Sign up for free.
So the Motels. What date? One more time.
October 22nd.
Yep.
Saturday. And we have, you guys got tickets.
No, Sunday. Friday.
Sunday.
Oh, it's a Sunday.
It
okay.
is a Sunday. But it's an early show. We play at 7 sharp, so you got to get there early. They have dinner tables open still, I think, too. Mm-hmm. So if you guys are down, it's going to be a super
reservations.
Cool show.
Hold on. October 27th?
22nd.
Oh,
22nd.
Oh.
Yeah, so we're doing the Rock City on the 20th.
Yeah.
And then
that's Sunday.
Yeah. And then the 21st, we might be doing something. special we'll talk about, possibly, and then your guys' show on Sunday. So it's going to be like a music-filled weekend.
Perfect. So,
freaking bitching.
Yeah.
All right. Where can people find you if they're interested? And they
Facebook.
SoundCloud, Reverb Nation.
Instagram. The Jelly. Ventura, California.
We make videos now. We cut down your performance on here. We put it out. So be on the lookout for that in the next couple of days.
Definitely. So.
We'll tag you.
All right. You guys ready to take us out with one more?
Oh, yeah.
This one you may or may not know. I should hope you do.
One makes you small, and the ones that your mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice when she's 10 feet tall. And if you go chasing a rabbit, going to fall dead like a hookah smoking caterpillar has given you the call to call Alice when she was just small.
Thank you guys so much. We will be right back with Ventura's Little Shop of Horrors after this on the Red Light District Show.
Thanks, guys. For the jelly. Love you.
We're back to the Red Light District Show. Ventura County's number one radio station, according to USA Today. Who are they, you know? Just legends in the publishing game. All right. On the show, our next guest, the owner?
Yes.
The owner of Ventura's Little Shop of Horrors. Welcome to Red Light Dish Show.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you for having me.
What's up, man? So, we see a bunch of abnormal stuff that you normally don't see every day.
Right.
On the table. So, we sort of know what's in Little Shop of Horrors by looking at this, right?
Pretty much, yeah. We got a lot of oddities and horror-related items. But it doesn't really stop there. We have a lot of different types of art. To kind of give an example, a lady came in a couple days ago, and she was going to bring in some artwork that she made. It's basically little pussy lips with real blood on them.
Whoa.
So okay. It goes from, it's not only like, you know, mummified rats or anything. It's like artwork of all different types and stuff like that. So it's just a lot of different things.
So what made you like, all right, I'm going to open up a store. I'm going to sell this shit. Like, what made you, how long was the journey for towards that goal?
Well, I've always collected oddities and horror-related items. What had happened was I got laid off from two jobs. And after I got laid off of the Haas Automation, it was like 200 of us got laid off. I had a pretty good collection, so I started selling it, realized you can kind of make some money. And so I decided just to open up shop and do something I really wanted to do. Just kind of started from there.
How's it going?
It's been going pretty good. Yeah, yeah, it's just been open for going on 2 years now. But when about 6-7 months after I opened, I had an accident at my normal 8-to-5. I was working at another place here in Oxnard, and so I was gone for almost a year shortly after I opened it, and just recently got back, moved into a slightly larger area, and everything's been going real good.
And you don't understand. I mean, it's been, you know, like, we'll walk down Main Street. I'll be down with Taylor. I'm down with her quite a bit, and for a year, been chomping at the bit of, what is Little Shop of Horrors? You know, she, feed me, Seymour. I want to go there, Dad. I want to go. And it finally opened, went in. It was like a freaking paradise of freak show. It is awesome.
Where is that?
433 East Main Street, number 8. We're in the Xander Building Alley, right by Rookie's Barn. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, I've been in the shop. I was in the. I think I was in it like the day before you moved from the other location.
Okay.
In the shop. It was very cool. I haven't been to the new location yet, but I'm glad to have that address now so we know exactly where
it
is.
Yeah, definitely stop on by. It's totally somebody, different.
Somebody got a, it was like a taxidermed, it was like a little bird, but it had two heads on it.
At the shop?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Yeah, there's stuff in there that I didn't even know we had. It was like, yeah, I was gone for a while, so a lot of the new stuff that was coming in, I wasn't aware of it. But yeah, there's some really weird stuff. We got different stuff every month, every week.
What do you, what is like your most prized possession? How do you look for this stuff? Do you go on eBay? Do you like search Reddit, dark web?
I do a lot of Facebook and a lot of closed groups, a lot of Etsy, a lot of eBay, just online, just constantly searching every day. I don't really have a prized possession. I've been doing this for so long, it's kind of seen everything for the most part. I'd have to say some of the higher end things at the shop right now are probably the Triceratops horn that we have. Pretty cool.
And it's real?
It's real. And we got a couple of human fetuses in there.
Oh,
those are real.
I've seen those. That is freaky shit. He's got a large one and a small one. It's a trip.
Yeah.
Hey, let's go through what we have on the table.
Well, right now.
Let him guess some of that stuff. I mean, yeah, you know, come sure. on.
All right. Dad, you want to go head-to-head or what? Or you want to go awesome? Who wants to go head-to-head with me? Mike? Or Fuse, one of you two.
I'll go head-to-head with you.
All right, Fuse will go. Let's
go with one of the small jars.
All right. All right, this one right.
All right. Hold on. Is that a heart?
I think it is a...
A seahorse.
A chicken fetus.
I can't see.
Yeah, I'm supposed to be guessing?
I'll bring it to you. I think it's a fetus of something.
I'm going to turn on my flashlight here.
Get your bifocals
up. So I've
got
this bottle of liquid. There's something. Oh.
It's an expensive bottle.
Okay, well, I think it's a hedgehog fetus.
Hedgehog? You say that.
Yeah, I tried to get you involved. You didn't want
to. You had your chance, Phil.
Yeah, you had your chance to be my friend. Is it a rat or a mouse? A rat?
That's what I think.
Or a kangaroo.
It's not a kangaroo. But we're both going with rodents.
I'm going to go with marsupial.
I'm going to go with rodent, and he's going with marsupial. All
right.
Everyone has to get their bifocals on. Oh, what do you know? See? What do you see?
Let me take a look at that, Sheen. Where am I? Hell am I?
Very
glasses?
Suspicious, see? Might be a human.
Where the hell are my dentures?
It's
all right, Austin, come get it from him. This is wasting too much time. You're bugging me now.
It could be a rat or something, you know, a mouse. Or
all right, so what one was that one?
That's a beaver fetus.
So marsupial, I was right.
Beaver in a marsupial?
No, you said a marsupial. Beaver is not a marsupial.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
No,
that's
not
a marsupial.
Don't worry about it. It is.
It's a mammal.
This one's harder. So I'm looking at another object in a It looks like Hellboy's middle finger. Baby Hellboy. It's, yeah, I have no idea what this is. I have no clue.
You're whack.
An owl fetus. Well, this is a brain. This one's definitely a brain.
Oh, this is definitely a penis, for sure.
Oh, is it? Well, you would know better than me.
No, this is a dick.
You've probably seen more than me. This is definitely a section of a brain. Maybe a monkey brain. I'm going to guess a section of a monkey brain.
Is that regular water?
No, that's alcohol. It's alcohol. Yeah, they all get preserved first in formaldehyde, and then from there we transfer them to alcohol.
Now, why the transfer?
Yeah, this is my wife's brain. It's about the same size.
Because the formaldehyde stops it from actually rotting. Yeah,
it's my wife's brain.
Stuff like that, it's going to, you know. But the reason we transfer it over
is because,
the
beaver is
the alcohol is a lot safer. So if one of these things ever breaks or anything like that, you really don't want that formaldehyde to be.
That's a good point.
Yeah,
that's
it's pretty
point.
Harsh stuff. So.
That's a rat.
So
it's got to be a monkey brain.
You know what's interesting is I've seen this before in your shop, or at least I saw one really similar.
We call them hellhounds.
But yeah, and I'm gonna you know, I remember guessing what it was and guessing wrong, and I don't remember what you told me, but I get my guess is that it's a rat.
I've really seen one of those
rats. Yeah, me too.
So you know, the little Samesies. Thing in the specimen jar was a penis. It's a Savannah monitor penis.
It looked exactly like that.
Yeah. I know dick.
Yeah, you do know
good.
Dick.
That's pretty good.
You know what? I don't feel bad about the fact that I got that wrong and you got it right.
Okay, what about the brain?
Human brain.
See, I told you about it.
Is that what you said?
Is it my wife's brain? Yeah. Pretty damn close. It's a rat, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
This one is?
Yeah, it's a rat. That's pretty.
That's nuts.
Mummified?
Yes.
Do you do that yourself?
I do. I have a friend and myself that do the mummification.
How do you do it? What's the process for that?
Well, the pigs, when we get them, those come...
That's a dog.
They're kind of the pinkish color like this, a fresh color. And they're probably about 3 to 4 times bigger than that. So I normally pose them. I have a hot box. I dehydrate them, and they just kind of stay like that.
Does it smell?
It smells like formaldehyde at first, but after they're done, they don't really have much of a smell to them.
What is that, Dad?
I think it's a dog.
A chihuahua.
So now, with your collection,
I'm going to say pig.
Your collection at the
one.
Store, is that your a personal pig? Collection, or do you have separate items that?
No, everything
your
that's
personal?
In the store now is stuff that I've purchased after I've opened up the store. My private collection is pretty much gone. I sold that all off. So,
are you looking for anything in particular?
I'm always
still?
Looking for stuff. Always.
Is there anything in your head that you're like, I want to find this?
Human skull.
Oh, I have those. I'd probably, you know what? Not really. Maybe a shrunken head, a real one.
What was that?
This is a replica one right here. Real ones normally start at about 8,000.
How did they make them that small?
They just shrink them. Yeah, they're just.
No, I know, but you have to. How do you form the brain to go that or the skull?
I'm pretty sure when they do those, they just kind of have like some type of what do you call it? Like I don't want to say a mold, but these ones right here are replicas, and that's alpaca, so it's not real, but. The real ones, I don't know, to be honest with you.
How many real shrunken heads, on average, are on the market?
A lot. If you have the money for them, a lot.
And yeah. How do you authenticate something like that?
You can
just take their word
for it? You
just
know. No, when you're into the stuff, it's just something like, you just know. Mm-hmm. You know, you can tell a fake skull from a real skull, regardless of how good the fake skull
now,
is.
Now, how old are they generally, these shrunken heads?
Oh, man.
This isn't a practice that occurs anymore, correct?
You know what? Even if it is, it's not something we can't get them anymore. They're not really allowed into the country. And we can't, you know, that's just so whatever's here is here, and that's it.
And what's do you know what the average age is of these shrunken heads?
No, you see kids. Oh,
what I mean is when they were shrunk, when it happened.
Oh, you see kids, old people, middle age.
No, what
people.
I mean is like what period of time? Like,
1912?
Do they tend to be from a different century or a certain century? Or
I'd probably say a lot of these are probably early 1900s.
Early
1900s. Yeah.
And usually of.
Late 1800s.
Not civilized society.
Yeah, no, because I've done a lot of reading, and a lot of times, you know, a relative would die, they'd shrink the head, give it to the kids to play with, and stuff like that.
Did you?
Obviously,
well, they used to do
different.
It.
It's pretty rock and roll.
They used to do it to their enemies, too, down there in South America.
Yeah.
That's rock and roll.
Yeah, they did.
So in all the years that you've been collecting items, have you ever come across any objects that were cursed or just had, like, an ill vibe to them?
Not yet.
Let's all stop it.
Not yet.
That's why I didn't want to touch that thing. I just told him right now. Yeah. I said,
it's a replica.
He said it's fake.
He came into our show. We're allowed to ask questions.
But I am looking for stuff like that. I am looking for, you know.
More voodoo type New Orleans.
Have you ever heard stories?
We plan on carrying all that stuff, yeah.
Have you ever heard stories of those types of objects from, you know?
All the time, yeah. You always hear. And then, like, the alley that we're in, the Xander Building, also, they say it's haunted. Mm-hmm. And we sell some books in there as well. Supposedly a man, a little girl in there that had gotten killed by her mom. And I guess it's a really well-documented story. I guess she got killed. Her mom drowned her in the tub in Ventura. And she was always going to the shop that I'm in right now. There was a guy that used to sell a lot of tarot cards there. And really well-known dude. He was there for years. He just recently passed away as well. Fuck. And but I guess she used to go to the store a lot. And she felt safe in there. And one day she went home. Her mom drowned her. And they say that that's where she went back, because that's where she felt safe. So
that's crazy.
But I've never seen anything.
And you've had Richard and Debbie Sennett in.
Richard Sennett's always in there. He's a really cool dude. Yeah. He's actually going to be there for the grand opening to sign his new book on November 3rd. So really excited about that.
Nice.
That's cool.
Now, do you strictly just carry oddities, or are there other types of items?
No, we carry oddities, all kinds of horror-related collectibles. We carry some rock and roll collectibles, goth, steampunk, and everything in between.
He's got a couple Nelson Cooper masks in there.
Yeah. You do?
Yeah, I got Nelson Cooper masks in there.
Yeah.
Dude.
What do you you said Triceratops horn. Right? We didn't make a big enough fucking deal about this, guys.
About a dinosaur?
A fucking dinosaur, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Right.
So you have this Triceratops horn.
Right.
Where were you when you first found it?
I went online. It was a chick named Ashley from Florida, and she works with a lot of paleontologists. And so she's always hooking me up with some really cool fossils and stuff like that. So.
And
really
then,
cool,
how much did you sell it to you for?
How much did she sell it to me for? How much am I selling it for?
Let's go. Let's not burn yourself out. Okay.
Let's find out what profit margin is.
It's right now. It's going for $55, but it is negotiable. $5,500. But you have to realize too that
I had money, if I wasn't a poor motherfucker, I'd be having 7 high triceratops in my house.
Well, just to kind of give an example, like a triceratops tooth can go for about $20,000. So,
tooth?
Yeah. So
that's
just
the
kinda,
first unicorn.
Yeah.
Just are you?
No, because it's they have 3, so it can't be.
First triad unicorn.
All right. So
descended.
They had for one tooth is $20,000.
Yeah.
And the horn's worth $55,000.
Well, yeah, because you got to remember that like Tyrannosaurus Rex is a little bit harder to find. I mean, they've only found like two whole, maybe one whole one, I think. They just made a documentary about it. And that thing sold for over $7 million. And there was a couple people that went into that to get it. So, and that was a big deal because the people that found it got screwed out of it. And
shit?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
They went into some private property. They paid the guy to buy the fossil, the whole thing. And then the guy went back and said that no, that didn't happen. They got screwed. The guys actually went to jail. They went to prison for it for years. And it's a really crazy documentary, but something that, should be
is
a lot
some
of fun
bullshit?
Doing. This is real.
No. What do you think? Who is fucked up in this?
Oh, the guy who owned the property.
So he just sent
him screwed
to jail?
He screwed him
over.
Well,
no, he found out what it was worth, and after he found out what it was worth, he went back on the agreement that he had with the people who found it.
Yeah, it was probably one of those things. Hey, we found bones. Great, bones. Here, take it for $50,000.
No, they told him.
And all of a sudden, it's like, boom, we found triceratops bones.
They told him up front what they had found.
Yeah, well,
and then when he discovered how much it was worth, is when
that's
jumped
when
back in the game.
I don't think anybody knew that it was going to go for that much. I know that when they found it, I think they gave them between $7,000 and $15,000, which at the time was a ridiculous amount of money. And when it went to auction, it went for 7-point-something million.
Oh my God.
So the guy went to a prison, and it was just a big ordeal. It's a really sad story.
The guy
cool
who sold went to prison?
The guy who bought it from the landowner got screwed and big time. So it's a really
How
sad
long
documentary.
Did he go away for?
A couple years.
It ruins a whole person's life to make one other person's life that much better.
Yeah.
I mean, when you get out of jail, there better be some million waiting for you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, I don't think you had anything.
It was called book deal after that. And it's when you make a book deal or a movie out of that.
See, the reason why the teeth are so much is because the thing to do these days is if you're wealthy, you buy the Triceratops or the dinosaur tooth, you have a couple of your teeth removed, and you have a dental procedure to have the dinosaur tooth put in your mouth, and you just eat with it for the rest of your life.
It's a smaller bone, so they don't last.
You're almost believing it, huh? Melissa, she's like, for real?
You know, I just want to say that I don't really know any of you guys, but I was talking to him right now. He says he works for the post office.
Yeah.
And he showed me some pictures right now. Like he said, 2 years ago, he had a box and a bunch of heads rolled out, and nobody wanted to touch it. And it's kind of crazy because he showed me the picture, and it was my box. That was 2 years ago.
Wow. And, so and they were awesome. Iguanas?
Yeah, they were all iguanas. So
what are the things you have? I want to know more things you have there.
Yeah, mummified iguanas. Right. Oh man, you just got to stop by. It's kind of, isn't it kind of hard to describe?
It is so hard to describe. I mean, you know, and I will say he did bring the neon seahorse.
The diaphanized seahorse.
Okay, that thing is.
Yeah.
What is the deal with that?
Diaphanization is when you stain the bones and the cartilage so you can see that basically their inner skeleton, and they're basically, you know, all the outer becomes transparent. So it's pretty cool. Oh, you can pretty. See the, yeah.
That's crazy.
So do you sell any implements, tools of torture, tools of surgery?
We do. We don't have any in right now, but we do. Yeah. Medical stuff, yeah.
Well, just, you know, if anybody wants to know where to get that stuff.
That's well, where it's hard to describe because you go in and there's a gremlin, you know,
right.
a foam latex gremlin in there. And then he's got, you know, a Stave Puft Marshmallow character. So you're seeing, all right, it's Halloween. You're seeing, you know, you're seeing the Halloween aspect of things. But then you turn and you see this very bizarre alien tooth bust that looks like it's like a steampunk looking alien.
Do you have
alien.
Any alien?
Or it's a replica.
I have aliens. I don't think I have any aliens right now.
No, have you no, ever? Well, that is there character. Anything on the market?
Alien stuff is kind of hard to find, at least like stuff that isn't cheesy, you know. Yeah. I try to get some really cool stuff in there. Haven't been able to find anything lately.
But I will say that even that bust you got in with the teeth, that's very alien-esque, you know. It's kind of like a steampunk alien fang looking.
You're talking about
devil.
The Black Widow woman?
Yeah.
I just got her in, and that's from Naomi Smith, an amazing sculptor. And that's a pretty cool piece. I forgot about that one.
Yeah.
That's cool.
As you walk around the room, you can go from the, okay, it's a mask, it's a skull, it's a skeleton, it's a, you know, just all different, you know, items. So, I mean, he's got bats. If you want a bat, it's a real bat, but it's like a little package. So, I mean, I just want one just to have a bat and, like, throw it at somebody. Here's a bat.
Right.
You know what I mean? But, and it's not expensive stuff. I mean, some of the stuff is a lot more pricey. You know what I mean? I mean, the seahorse is not cheap, you know, but for what it is, who's got that?
Right.
You know what I mean? So just to have that on a lighted display, I mean, that's a badass little piece.
You probably don't have many competitors, I would think, right?
Not here. No. There's a Necromance out in L.A., but we're a little bit different than Necromance because we carry all the horror-related items and all the, the bands. So like, I have some Motley Crue collectibles in there, some Motorhead collectibles, Metallica, Guns N' Roses. So I'm going to be getting a lot more of that stuff as well.
You know, I was in Hollywood years and years and years ago, mm-hmm. and I wandered into we were actually filming something out there. I don't remember what it was anymore, but I wandered into some store. I can't remember exactly where it was. It might have been on Melrose, and all it was just like it was like torture tools and implements and pincers and prongs
like
and
the pleasure
razor
chest.
Blades and
but
it
in
was.
The back room.
No, it's just everything was laid out in a display. They had old-fashioned dental tools,
okay,
and scalpels, and that's.
You know what they actually had two doors down or a couple doors down from his place. Times Remembered has that.
That's a cool store. That's a really cool store.
They actually have a lot of the old medical tools.
Really?
Yeah, at Times Remembered. Yeah.
I have to go check.
But
that out.
But the vibe in this place was horror. It wasn't. Everything was very clean and laid out, but it was definitely kind of a scary place. Right. You know, I'd never seen anything
it. But you know, like his, I could best compare it to. I mean, those people who know, like, and, you know, especially like in North Hollywood, I would say it's Dapper Cadaver Light. I mean, because Dapper Cadaver has, you know, they got more of the anatomical skeletons and,
right,
you know, and
do,
like
yeah.
blobs of fat. I mean, they cater to the Hollywood industry.
Actually, the mermaid I have is from Dapper Cadaver.
Yeah.
The mermaid up on top of the,
yep.
Yeah, that's from
you know,
Dapper
and a
Cadaver.
Lot of it is, it's a lot of stuff that they use for CSI, you know, mm-hmm. for any of the CSI shows.
Do you think that there's such thing as mermaids or fairies? Because I've seen a lot of these, like mummified, like supposed mermaid, supposed right. fairy.
I think a lot of the stuff that you see is fake. I think it is possible. I mean, everything. I mean, just not too long ago, they found, you know, they find all kinds of new things all the time out there in the wild. So, it's very possible. But I think a lot of stuff out there right now is fake. Yeah.
Have you ever seen that show? It used to be on TV. It was called Oddities, and they used to sell all this kind of stuff.
It was a series.
Oddities in New York and San Francisco Oddities as well.
Right.
Really cool people out in San Francisco. Actually, both. I've talked to both of them. Really, really nice people out there. So they're awesome.
Cool. That's it. What was that about, Dad?
Nothing. I was just wondering if he
knew
the show.
That's it. You got nothing, Phil?
It was about the same thing that
he said. He was going to follow up a question. Hey, you ever know about the sun? All right, yeah. Just want to know if you know him.
just know if you know the sun.
Dad, what? Well, I thought you were, honestly, I was getting curious.
I was waiting for you to go somewhere, too.
What I was saying was they sell that kind of thing. Huh?
Yeah, I thought there was like another question to it.
A bunch of fucking idiots. Shut up.
Did you think there was another?
I was waiting. I was waiting too. So yeah, just kind of.
I was like, what the hell's going on?
Well, I was just wondering if he's seen the show. And
but
if
I have. Great show.
And about the same things.
Right.
It was about.
Do you play Words? Do you play Words with Friends?
Have you ever seen Friends? The
Words with Friends. It's an app.
No.
Do you use Android or iPhone?
Android.
Android.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He was just pointing out that.
No, you're right. Phil's
method
doesn't work.
Yeah, neither do your paintings that you use.
You need a new one, man.
Oh, you should sell one of his paintings in your store.
Who's that?
Him.
That'll scare the shit out of anybody.
I do have a self-portrait that would actually fit in your store.
Really, that'd be awesome.
Of yourself?
That'd be great.
I did a self-portrait.
Why don't you make one of him?
I am going to paint
him.
Did
you draw it? Or did
I will
you
say
no, I painted
Fuse,
it.
Fuse does have some really badass artwork that would actually go pretty badass.
Yeah, yeah, bring it by. Whenever
for
you're
sure.
In the area, man.
That,
cool.
That'd be a good little outlet for you right
you got,
there.
You got a lot of people looking
yeah,
for local
do
artists.
Do some consignment
stuff
or
in there. Yeah,
you know,
be cool.
I've only painted 4 pieces in my life. Phil has seen and criticized all 4. But the
hey,
the,
Tim, you're an artist,
but
right?
But the self-portrait, you know, it came out kind of dark.
Really?
And people are like, oh, yeah, you captured your essence.
Look like Anson?
That's cool. That's awesome. Yeah, we're always looking
great
to bring
job,
you art, man. So
great job.
Yeah, if you want, just go ahead and bring it by.
Wow. Isn't that fancy?
Who did that?
Awesome.
Is that Chris, is that your work?
That's mine.
No.
I'm finding Tim has a plethora of artwork around the room that sometimes is entertaining to pull out every once.
Yeah, it is. Really entertaining.
Have you seen someone else's collection and like, damn, that's fucking cool. I want that. Like, what is something that you've seen that's one of a kind?
I was actually read an article a couple weeks ago, and I want to say it was in Russia, and they had this crazy human fetal collection, and babies had all kinds of deformities, two-headed babies. It was crazy. It was such a wicked collection. That would be a cool collection.
So it's like the Barnum or the Ripley's type stuff.
Pretty much,
like
yeah.
It
was crazy, and all this stuff was real. So some of the Plastination stuff that you see that Vegas has right now, that's really cool stuff. That would be cool to have, but that stuff is crazy expensive.
But no, but he does have babies in the shop, real babies.
Yeah.
Fetal babies.
Hopefully we won't get anybody tomorrow protesting or doing something to shut down the store.
Do we have any, what's your favorite horror movie? I see you wearing a Devil's Reject shirt. So
love that movie.
Be,
that's one of my favorites.
That's one of my favorites.
Yeah, it's an awesome movie. I think it's the Rob Zombie's best movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy good. Man, horror movies nowadays, you know, I still got to watch Exorcist. I haven't finished watching it. Everybody gives me a hard time about it because everybody's seen it, but I haven't. So I'm still in the process of watching that. But horror movies, man. Probably the old school Nightmare on Elm Street stuff when I grew up watching them because they scared the shit out of me. Nowadays, everything is just so, you know, fake and just, mm-hmm. You get kind of callous now.
Super over the top.
Yeah,
huh?
So it's just more.
Well, I think those movies
anymore.
Back in the day were a little bit less gore, kind of like even how Hitchcock did it, where you didn't see the stabbing and, you know. You just saw the blood on the floor behind
yeah,
the shower curtain.
No,
you know
I didn't
mean?
Like Hitchcock.
I think, you know, I mean, Hitchcock yeah, Nightmare on Elm Street had it when they're injecting, you know, in the
right.
later films. But
right.
most of it was more the spook versus the gore. You know what I mean? The blood and violence.
Well,
it was
I
more
thought
like,
was
just
like
scare. The nails screeching across the wall.
I was like a 4-year-old kid watching that shit, right, Dad? I mean, I'm used to seeing nothing but, like, Teddy Ruxpin. And then all of a sudden I see some dude.
Did you see Ted?
Yeah,
and then it went to Ted getting his head ripped off.
Yeah. All right. Do you have a Facebook or social media?
We do. We have Facebook, Ventura's Little Shop of Horrors, and on Instagram we're Ventura_horror, and we just got our website up and running. And so yeah, it's www.Ventura's Little Shop of Horrors, VTA, something like that. It'll pop up on the Facebook. I forgot. It just got up and running, so something like that.
Awesome. Well, buddy. Thank you so much for coming by.
Oh, thanks for having me. You got an awesome place here, dude. I love it. Really cool.
Awesome.
Nice vibe, man.
Hey, anytime
cool.
you want to come by and just
hang out,
man. I
appreciate that. I really do appreciate that. That's awesome.
This is let this be your little sanctuary if you ever need.
Oh, that's cool, man. Definitely come back and have a beer with you guys. You guys are all really cool people, man.
What's
Thank
with
you.
The butterfly, though?
It's a moth. It's an Atlas moth from okay. Indonesia. All
right.
So, yeah.
And then a skull of a saber-toothed tiger.
Yeah, actually, the skull and the shrunken head I brought for you guys for a little decor.
That's not a saber-toothed tiger.
So, serious?
Yeah, for you guys, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
I really, really appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem, man. Thanks
He's
for having
fucking
me.
Fucking awesome. All right, let's give it up one time.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, we'll be right back with the world's greatest segment and What'd You Learn right after this.
Is that a dog's head?
It's a black bear skull. It's a replica because they're illegal to sell in California, so you want to stay away from all that stuff.
We'll be right back.
nice and nice to know you. Let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend to you. It was like food for all of my senses. Our time priceless, no expenses. Like water to all them dry trenches. She had a theme song for her every entrance. We had a dinner and a movie. Fire up the doobie. Grace 5 foot. This girl school closer to me. I call her babe. She call me boogie. Her beauty intelligence really moves me. Nice and nice to know ya. Let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend to ya. Nice and nice to know ya. Let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend. This isn't my first rendezvous in a relationship. Well, round it, graduated with love certificates. Hey, she want a lover I'll be. Stimulate your body and mentally. Hey, don't bust me straight up in a liar. You love me surely if you want to cry. My love is real, not like the mother guys. Feel sorry for who signed up, cause me, I win first prize. Nice to know ya, let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Wanna be more than a friend to ya. Nice and nice to know ya. Let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend to ya. She looking pretty real nice. Like the room up, she have the perfect body type. Being with you is like being in paradise. Never seen a girl that can live up to the hype. Ay. She is a wife, I'm more busy, more than I eat him all along. Big up to the Caribbean girl, I keep it proper. All of me Latinos and all of me sexy mamas. Broken Corleone, giving you a holler. Nice to know ya, let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend to ya. Nice to know ya, let's do it again. How we did it on a one night stand. Girl, I wanna be more than a friend to ya.
We're back to Red Light Dish Show. All right. That was pretty cool, huh?
It was. Hey, I got a thing. You know, how come most, you know, well, I guess it's just because it's a matter of I'm an October kid, but, you know, when you get the most October Libra birthdays, and Fuse has actually mentioned this as well.
Sure, birthday, Fuse?
Happy birthday, you know, bro. We're all in,
happy
like,
birthday,
death and gore.
Happy birthday.
When was your birthday?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Today, Friday the 13th.
Happy birthday.
October 13th.
Boom.
Lucky.
But, you know, October, you find it's death, doom, and gloom. You know, most everybody's kind of into it. We're kind of into that horror gore thing.
But you can't say that. I mean, I was born in April, and I'm into the same shit.
So. Yeah, but you're also into bondage, and that's weird.
I think that's bullshit, but it's also totally true.
That is weird.
No, I think you're right.
April's a weird month.
You know, how come Christmas babies aren't all like, you know, Santa Claus? I know a lot of people in December as well. And they're just like not all about Santa Claus. And,
I don't know. I know some people born in December that are pretty haunted. You know, so but it's cold. It's winter, you know, so maybe that has something to do with it.
Spooky.
I've always been haunted. I've always been haunted since I was a little kid.
Well, I mean, even when I was little, I mean, my birthday is mid-October, so I always had, like, the cakes with, like, you know, candy corn-type, you know, things in them and little pumpkins and
that
those
sucks.
Types of things.
Sorry.
Well,
why does it suck?
Because who wants to eat fucking candy corn in their cake?
I was born with Halloween on the inside. I didn't even like candy corns. Like when I read Alone by Edgar Allan Poe, I actually identified with that. I was like, holy shit, that's me.
Oh. I never read it.
Nobody else has read it here, so you were alone.
I know you guys don't read.
All right. That's reading a book.
Do you guys want to know
Not
the
really.
Top 10? Let me see. Fuck you.
Who are you, Phil? Get with All the right. list.
Jesus.
The top 14 creepiest websites that are available on the net.
ChristianMingle.com.
Yeah, for real.
Number 5.
Number 1, Farmers Best Gore. Plane crash info, where they have audio audios of the plane, like black boxes.
I've been there.
They have the plane going down?
No, they have the audio of everything happening, like inside the cabin.
Oh, that's disgusting. Recordings. Why would anybody want to listen to that?
Because they need to find out what was the cause. Like, did it just go down? Or
well,
were
he
mean
regular, like general people. Like, yeah. Obviously, why the investigators would listen, but why would general people want to listen to that?
Oh, it's a train crash.
Number 3, White Enamel, a horrifying walk through all abandoned psychiatric hospitals. Psychiatric.
Like psychiatric hospitals.
Death map. Cataloging the world's deaths in real time. Mm. So it's a map, and every time someone dies, you get lights.
Oh, shit. That'll make you
morbid.
How does
it know, though?
I'm not watching that one.
Hashima Island, a place to explore the real forgotten world of the coast of Japan.
Oh, yeah.
Death date. A site where they will tell you exactly when you die.
Yeah, when you die. I thought it was deathclock.com.
Death date. So
that one's just stupid because it's completely random.
Really? But now apparently there's a different one, death date.
Yeah, that one, you fill out a questionnaire and it will tell you exact date. Scientifically.
Scientifically?
Scientifically.
That's
how the hell do they know that?
True. It's not interesting because it's not true.
It's on the web. It's true.
How are though, Mike Fuse is scared of this. That's
no,
why.
Yes, you are. No.
Bullshit.
You're telling me
you are fucking scared.
Have you ever had a medical issue and you're going to the doctor and they can't figure it out? You know, and you have to keep going back. You get tests and everything.
Bullshit.
You're gonna tell me some guy's doing a website that you fill out a little form and they know when you're gonna die and they know your genetics and your history.
You do it then, Mike. If you're
accidents and the environment.
Why don't you do it this week?
Let's find out.
It is non-scientific.
Let's do it this week.
It doesn't matter what the date that comes back because to me it's completely arbitrary.
Okay. You're not scared of it.
Totally
scared. I'm scared of it. I admit it. You do it then.
Scared of getting an arbitrary date?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tim, I know when you're going to die.
Okay, cool.
I know things. Do you want to know?
No, I don't give a fuck.
I can tell
know.
You right now if you want to know.
I don't want to fucking know.
I'll tell you. Do you want to know?
No.
Because I'll tell you.
No. I want to know.
This isn't Final Destination.
Tell me so.
I don't want to know.
You know what? I think it also has the power
of
the
Who dies first, me or my dad?
It's also like the power of the secret. You know what I mean?
You really want to know.
If you're willing.
Yeah. That means you do.
Oh, yeah. You might put
I don't want to cry, man. I don't want to tell you.
It's me. I'm glad. I hope you fucking cry, bro. I hope you cry. I hope you throw yourself on my coffin.
Oh,
and
yeah.
You're like, I love you. I'm sorry I never told you when you're alive.
You can't do that because you're...
I'm sorry.
It'll be an urn.
No, I'm not kidding. No, no.
Yes.
I get a burial
bull
from the fucking military.
I do know what kind of burial I want. I really have always wanted a Viking burial. Because I don't want to be in a coffin, and I don't want to be cremated in an urn.
You got to find an archer
on a boat
time.
And pushed out to sea, and somebody
and
shoot.
On
yeah,
fire.
You got to find a good. You got to hire an archer ahead of time at least.
Yeah, I want a Viking funeral.
Like, lo there, do I see my mother?
Everyone's all homeless because
yeah,
they have
exactly.
to pay for his
That's
funeral.
Pretty fucking awesome.
I think those are the best ones.
I'm down.
Now, do you have Viking blood?
I do.
In your line.
Yes.
Well, why are you everything now?
You got Indian blood. You got every blood.
Yeah,
Chief Big Feather.
Odin.
Odin.
No. I do have a lot of different mixes. It's crazy. I do.
Oh, wow.
Right.
I'm going to bring in my genealogy book for you that my mother-in-law gave me. It's like this thick. I'm going to bring it in. We just, you know, we're moving, so I just found it the other day.
What's your mother-in-law?
Nepal.
What's it got to do with you?
She was a dragon.
She's a genealogist, so she did the whole history and gave us the book.
She was a dragon.
A dragon from Nepal.
I got dragon blood too. My eighth great grandmother was Snarls the dragon.
Oh jeez.
And you're
right,
kind of defensive on the unicorn shit too. I'm
Jethro
sure
information, a real time database of when death row inmates of death row's inmates last words.
That's rad.
That is pretty cool.
And last meal. Do they have last meals too on that?
I want to
know.
Yep.
And last meals. Yes. Wait, but do they have like a rank system of like best last word? Or is it just a...
No, it's
like
just a rank.
They usually have the same last word.
Oh, shit!
Yep. That's about it.
Don't do that no more, Mike. Or Fuse, either.
You just want to tell both of them.
I'm just making sure both of you idiots know. Both of them.
Some death row inmate blood, too.
Number 8. Bong Chion Dong like Ghost. Bong Chion Dong Ghost.
All I hear is bong.
It's an online comic that will scare the shit out of you.
.com.
You can also order it at Lucky Tie down by SeaWorld.
Number 9.
It'll still get you really high.
Crypto Mundo. Scary accounts of people encountering creatures that shouldn't be real.
Nice. It's like half the shit he had on the table.
Number 10. Fifth Nail. A convicted serial killer and violent sexual predator blog. So it's this dude who kills and fucking sexual predatizes on people, and he writes about it, how he does it.
What does he do?
Is that a word?
Sexual predatizes.
Dog predatizes.
I was just sexual predatized.
I was just predatizing.
Predatizing.
Hey, who is sexual predatized?
Y'all never predatizes it?
Motherfucker.
I was leaving right the answer? Deli.
Fucking racist.
I predatized, you know what I'm saying?
I predatized.
All he's y'all. All y'all be predatized.
He's from the South. He's a white dude.
Shut up, Chris Austin.
Number 11, Skyway Bridge. Funny. Tracking the suicides from one of the most suicidal bridges in the USA.
Is that in Pasadena?
The Sunshine Sky Bridge.
In Minnesota?
That's the name of it?
It's on the west coast of Florida.
That's not a good name for the most suicidal bridge in the United States.
At the mouth of Tampa Bay.
Oh, Tampa Bay, yeah.
It's the number 4 suicide bridge in the country. Like, how do you say? All right, that's number 1, 2, 3. I guess it'll be number 4.
No, the one in Pasadena. A lot of people, they had to raise the fences.
Number 1
on
in
that
East
one.
Coast.
That's the 4th Street
Wasn't
bridge.
Wasn't there that bridge?
Oh, no. That's
it's
not,
right
it's
off
LA.
Of, not Colorado.
There's that big long bridge that you go over going to Lake Kachuma, too. That used to be one, too. Or
okay, so check this out. In 2005, 10 suicides, 13 attempts, 2 saves. In 2006,
we gotcha!
5 suicides, nope. 17 possibles, 1 survivor of a jump, and 1 save.
Oh. That would just suck.
Survive.
I lived!
And you're all fucked up.
You might come out with a new perspective. Whole
I'm in
new
heaven.
Lease on
that's
life.
True.
Yeah.
2015, 12 suicides, 15 possibles, 2 survivors, 10 saves. 2015 was the largest month for the suicides.
Out of all the websites you listed, this is the only one where you're really focused on it, giving it love.
Because I give a fuck.
Yeah, this is the one you're really into.
Well, I mean, the other ones are pretty cool, too. Like the black box one, like who... You know, that's pretty
well,
wild.
If anybody's having troubles out there, we have NAMI out here in Ventura County.
Darwin Time, a borderline incoherent compilation of conspiracy theories and disturbing images.
Oh, shit, that's Facebook.
Number 13, 2 more. A Columbine site cataloging the 1999 mass shooting.
That's horrible, dude.
Has anybody seen the videos of that?
Yeah, dude, I actually just educated Taylor on Columbine. And a lot of people, how many shooters were in Columbine?
2.
2.
Right. A lot of people only think there was 1, Dylan
really?
Klebold. Yeah. That's the name that's been most publicized, but there was 2.
Eric Harris.
Yep. And it's one of those things that we started talking about the shooting, and I wanted to see like if they were talking about it in school, because we were talking about the Vegas shooting. And so her and I just started talking, and then it led to the Columbine stuff. And you know, and so it was one of those things. What do you do? That was where our conversation went. Well, what do you do? What would we do, Dad, you know, if that happened? And so I said, hey, I said, let me show you, you know. But then I went, and I didn't realize how much footage was online. Everything's online. They actually show one of
them killing themselves.
Yeah.
Well, I fucking see.
They actually show, I mean, for, and it was almost 3 hours worth of footage, which was the cafeteria footage. And so I didn't want to show her any of the other crazy
It's not a
footage.
Good idea to watch that stuff, you know.
It is when you want to educate, you know what I mean? And that's the thing.
Well, why would you watch someone kill themselves?
You know what,
No. I didn't
I'm
watch
disgusting.
Any of that. No,
There's no,
no
excuse
no.
for me.
No. I didn't watch any of that part. We watched the from, you know, just everybody running their day life, you know, in a cafeteria, and the kids coming in, you know, it was empty. Then all of a sudden it fills up right around lunchtime, and all of a sudden all S happens, and all of a sudden it's like, well, what do you do? And you don't see that, you know, people getting tagged out. You just see an explosion, see a lot of clouds. You see the sprinklers go off. The floor's got water. You see the SWAT come in. I mean, this is a three-hour, you know, video. So, you know, you don't see the guys come in with trench coats, but you see the flashes in the corners. And there's multiple cameras, and it keeps changing out. And it's creepy as hell. But it's one of those things of, like, even my daughter was saying, it's like, the stairway's right there. Why are they still sitting under the table?
Yeah, I could save you.
Why? And then you got the other guy sitting up against the wall. You know, why are they still there if all this is going on? I said, but look at them. I said, they're pretending to be dead because all this craziness is happening. I said, so, you know, their best mechanism to them as self-preservation is to play dead, you know. And I said, where you see every once in a while, then you see the teachers and, I don't know, you know, what, you know, authoritative role they had, but you see them running frantically through the room, and all of a sudden you see big flash, and a big smoke comes in through, and then sprinklers go off, and then at one point in time when, you know, things were kind of calm for a while, that's when you see the kids who were under the table. It was that fight or flight. You know what I mean? They're like, we're out! You know what I mean? They just ran to a flash over
so
to
no
the left.
So no gore?
They ran the opposite way.
Did you see any gore?
No, didn't see any gore in that film.
That's the stuff that affects me. Some asshole on Facebook one time, a couple years ago, shared a video of a kid in I can't remember what the country was. I don't know if it was Indonesia or where it was. They had piranhas, and this kid was literally half eaten by piranhas. Ugh. Little kid, probably about 7 years old. And the dad is pulling the boy out of the water and holding him and crying and screaming. The kid is dead, and he's half a skeleton. I mean, that destroyed me to see that. I've never gotten that out of my mind. I unfriended that. I replaced it. Like, one of the only things I've ever – maybe the only thing I've ever reported. And it wasn't – they said it was fine, but it destroyed me. I'll never forget it. Can't get the
image out of
my head.
You know what? I mean, because we were talking about the Harvest 91 Festival, you know, and so that's kind of where it all came from. So, I mean, even that – I mean – I let her see the only videos that I let her see, which was, you know, showing on stage with Jason Aldean and then kind of panning over and hearing the gunshots.
Yeah.
Okay. Not, I mean, some of the photos that have been on Facebook of, like, you know, there's a couple of gals laying on the ground with blood and that kind of stuff. So disrespectful. The people who,
right.
I mean, there's been a couple people who I even know who use it as a profile photo. And I'm like, you mother effers. I mean, how dare you? Wait, you know, if that was
or
your
people
kid,
that
your
say
mom,
it didn't
sister,
happen, it was actors, and they put these pictures out. This is fake.
And the thing is I don't know anybody personally who, you know, in direct contact who got shot or died. But I know people, my friends, who went to that event, and their friends were either shot or killed. So, I mean, it's one of those things that, you know, so I was trying to, you know, do an education because she knows about it. She heard it. It's part of the community of the stuff that I run with. And so, you know, showing a Columbine thing, showing a, you know, a Sandy Hook, you know, type thing is, you know, for me, it's, you know, my daughter's 9. You know what I mean?
You
shit
know
like
that whole Sandy Hook
shit
thing?
Shit like this happens nowadays. And I know that my kid, you know, and
you know.
You know
the whole Sandy Hook thing? Like, people are trying to, like, I probably have said that there was some evidence that didn't add up to it. But people, I saw a fake video of them saying, it was a fake video of Sandy Hook.
Right.
They kept on saying, oh, look, they're going in circles.
Yeah.
And they're not going in circles.
Right.
It was a repeated loop.
And that's the problem. You said the word evidence, and the shit that people put online that, you know, is not evidence. You know, seeing a video is just not evidence.
No.
At
not
all.
Nowadays.
Because they can easily be manipulated. There's conspiracy theories for absolutely everything. Sandy Hook is another one that gets me, too, because it's children.
Yeah,
you know that one destroyed me too. You know, I can't watch any of that stuff. But the conspiracy stuff really, you know, pisses me off.
Well, for the conspiracy folks out there, October 26th is the day that all John F. Kennedy's apparent assassination.
Brain matter.
His assassination. What is it?
Well, there's documents that are going to be released. You know what they're going to show?
I forget what the commission was that did the investigation after his death, but those documents will be released.
They're going to be released. You know what they're going to show? Nothing.
Who knows?
If there was a conspiracy, it's not in those documents.
If there was and it was in those documents, they will not be among those released, I can tell you that.
Those went around file with fire.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, who knows? Maybe some new stuff will come out.
There's a few things I think there is a conspiracy about. John F. Kennedy is definitely one of them. 9/11 being another one, for sure. Without a shadow of doubt in my mind, I know that.
You think we attacked ourselves?
I'm you see, 100%
this is
sure.
100% sure.
This is what drives me crazy.
This, Tim, so it's really disappointing to hear you say that.
Fly into a building?
You're basing this on videos you saw on Facebook,
nope.
On YouTube?
Nope.
And, you, and the Earth's round, right?
Some conspiracy some conspiracy idiots from the internet, you know, is what he believes.
It's just like me being a Mason. People come up. I've seen websites about shit that we supposedly do, and it's absolutely not.
Am I alone in this 9/11 shit?
I hope so.
Totally. Yeah.
No. I hope so.
You're totally alone.
No.
You're
what's
I'm on Tim's side.
What about you?
It's just fishy. There's a lot of weird details that just don't make sense.
Building 7. Explain that one, bro.
A lot of shit fell on another building.
No, that's not what happened, Dick.
Okay, I'll let you tell it. You weren't there.
He's a dick because...
Oh, I'm sorry, fucking firefighter Austin.
I mean, I don't know that you have a degree in engineering, do you?
Yeah, so there.
I don't know that you're a disaster scene investigator.
I do know that's the first time in history.
Hold on, Tim.
People do.
You're a layman.
Every building is up to code that was built in the. When was New York built? When were the Trade Towers built?
The Trade Towers were built in the '70s.
You think but that was up
were,
to code?
Yeah, I do believe it.
They weren't built for.
It was a very big deal
for major airliners.
It was built for a 707 to go into it.
Yeah, they were.
Which is better?
I've never heard anybody with a high degree ever say that that shit was a conspiracy.
Oh, you drive me fucking.
Well, no, what they're actually saying is that it was a controlled demolition.
They interviewed.
Yeah, I know. I've seen that. It's in.
They interviewed the architect of the building, and the architect of the building, firsthand from him, said that they were designed to withstand
but
the impact.
This is based on shit you saw online
says
in
the
video.
Of a building that fell.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it was designed to do that.
No, it's the guy who designed it, though, so his work does have credence to it.
He doesn't want his shit to be known to be falling.
So jet fuel melts steel beams.
Jet fuel does not burn.
It doesn't.
That's
burn
what
that
you guys
high.
Are basically arguing.
I worked with jet fuel for 12 years.
That's another one of the
and
arguments.
That's one of the things you will never convince me
but
otherwise.
I know enough about metallurgy to know that if you to know that if it gets hot enough,
stupid.
It'll bend and it'll fall.
You said something interesting.
You said something interesting. You said that you'll never
change your mind no matter what.
And the argument from that side is that jet fuel doesn't burn hot enough to do that to metal.
If you got enough of it, if you got 10,000 gallons of it, it will.
If jet fuel's burning, it doesn't matter how much of it you have. It's only going to burn to a certain
because Red Light District Show is a consortium of degreed scientists. I love this debate about what fucking jet fuel does.
No, but see,
you know, I consider myself
I was in the Navy.
So?
So what?
Big deal.
Aircraft.
Wait.
So?
I went to college.
I was a fucking aircraft mechanic.
I taught myself how to play guitar.
Just because you twisted a wrench doesn't make you a freaking scientist.
The thing of it is this. Hold on. The thing of it is this, right? Is we're people and we have opinions and we're allowed to have our opinions.
Oh, absolutely. But it doesn't mean that an opinion is correct. An opinion or a value can be wrong.
I've got an
I'm
not saying that it can't.
So
you can argue opinions.
Can solids and liquids be changed with temperature?
That's correct.
Like, solids and liquids can be that's a definite thing, right? And then so certain 100%. Solids can be changed with certain temperatures, and then there's the opposite, where they can't.
And that's when they're built correctly, right?
So, but that's...
Chris, when did you become this fucking scientist?
There's no scientists here.
When you were in buildings?
The Navy, did they teach you about jet fuel? They told you exactly what jet fuel...
The temperature... Ask him.
You got a master's in jet fuel.
Hold on. No. Chris. Yes. Mike, Chris. Mike here. I can't hear him.
There it is.
Yes, we went through this boring ass class for jet fuel. All
right, what's the fuel called, Tim?
JP5.
JP5.
What color is it?
It's like piss color.
It goes through purple tubes.
Wow. Piss color, purple tube.
We know all about it because it goes
through purple
tubes.
There's a whole lot of education and
that's
knowledge.
Okay, but then that's like...
And what was the thickness of the beams of the tower?
And were they the right ones? And was it
what type of steel
copper,
was it? Were there any impurities in the steel? Who made the steel? Mm-hmm. And what is the point at
which? I'm pretty
sure
they went back to it. And do you know the heat?
You know, none of
the
heat signatures.
The questions that you're asking have been answered.
But yeah, the preeminent scientists,
and then you're just getting mad at them because they're listening to
doesn't agree with any of this.
No, so there are people who are preeminent scientists who do agree with it. So I mean, that's not an accurate statement.
Okay. I don't think that's true.
I don't think that any legit scientists are on board with that.
I know,
conspiracy
but
theory.
It doesn't matter.
But
if you think it's true. It is true. Is the point that I'm
it
making?
It doesn't matter that you say it is true. It isn't
what I'm
true.
Saying is that what I'm saying, Fuse, is that there are people who disagree with you.
On the
you're
internet.
Not, and you're not
me.
He can't accept it.
Well, that's
I can't accept it. Because you guys saw some websites and some videos.
No, because Building 7 went down. That's some bullshit.
That could be the same thing
you're
saying.
What about the Pentagon? You wanted to... Let's go there,
oh,
buddy.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Here it comes.
The Pentagon. It was,
did you call me buddy or butthead?
Okay. Yeah, Fuse.
Anybody see a fucking plane?
Yeah, it was a missile.
It was a missile.
It wasn't a plane.
It was a missile?
There you go.
Yes.
There you go.
You
wait a minute.
Dickheads.
No, wait, let me ask you a question.
Just because you saw it on TV.
When you were at the
Pentagon,
just because you saw the video of a plane going into a building and it not there anymore.
A video is not evidence.
I know, but exactly.
No, there's no video out there.
No one saw
the plane striking the Pentagon.
No
there
one
there
saw
were cameras.
There doesn't
there
need
were cameras
to be.
Facing toward it, but all of that video
that
was
shit.
Confiscated.
There doesn't need
and
to be
and
a video
the eyewitnesses,
of it.
And all the eyewitnesses of a plane going into the Pentagon.
Yeah, and all the eyewitnesses.
Well,
there's no debris of the fucking airplane there.
Because I know how the real world works.
And oh yeah, it burns. Yeah, this magic.
You know there are thousands and thousands
they
of people involved in these
the
investigations that are
debris.
Trained.
There
you know what?
Debris.
It's just
they
like this thing in
license.
Vegas.
They even found the IDs.
All these people with these conspiracy theories. You know, it's not possible. You've got the Las Vegas Police Department dealing with the largest modern massacre in history.